Microphone check, 1, 2, man.
What is this? Gemini Scorpio Podcast bringing the business.
Okay, you just ruined our intro.
Shot a button, I guess.
No, we cannot copy.
He said, JP B-Boys back.
I know, I got it from somewhere. Well, shout out to the Joe Budden Podcast. You like them. That's they guy.
He's cool. That's his idol.
Wow. No.
The street said. I ain't gonna tell you what the street said.
Yeah, I heard. Nigga said, yeah.
Yeah.
Y'all ain't say shit.
The streets, according to the streets, they saying Jay out here off his Joe Budden. That's just what the streets say. You know what I'm saying?
I ain't gonna lie. Somebody did call me. He was like, yo, it was an artist in Baltimore. He's like, bro, you ain't know the artist was in Baltimore? That's because you too busy in this podcast shit.
Ooh.
And I ain't know what to say. I was like, damn.
Damn.
Damn. Is that where we coming to?
I hope that's where we end.
Gemini J is in the business.
No.
Gemini
Scorpio Podcast here.
No, remember DJ Gemini?
Yeah, he worked for KY's.
He probably like, yeah, this little nigga up here. He bite my swag.
Whole time, no.
Biting my swag.
Whole time, a Scorpio, though.
That's wild.
Really?
DJ Gemini is a Scorpio.
So why is his name Gemini?
I don't know.
That's false advertising.
I wish I had. Damn, I don't even have a shit.
I can't even connect to the damn thing.
I can't even connect to it.
Remember when Ja Rule did that Fyre Festival and he said, it's not fraud, it's false advertising.
No, facts.
Like, what's the difference?
Niggas don't answer my phone calls. I ain't really plug like that.
And nah, when nobody answers my call, like, I be feeling like
the fuck offended. Is up?
Yeah, like, what's good?
Fuck with me. Fuck it. DJ Gemini Scorpio. Shout out to him. But Gemini Scorpio Podcast here. Mr. J Hill.
Hiller Bay is here.
Miss Grinaway.
Alexander DeBlanc.
How come I ain't get no hype?
She does this every week.
I do that to Alex every week.
Oh, okay.
It's just like
How was y'all week, yo? Speaking of the weeks.
I had a great week.
That's good.
I had a great week. I'll start my week first. I got a lot of new opportunities. I'm getting into some new ventures. I'm very excited.
My man did two videos as the main character in a video.
Yo, the video would look good, though.
It looked great.
It was on Vivo, too, so it looked legit.
She did such a good acting job. Yeah, so she legit.
I saw his videos, but I didn't know who he was.
Yeah.
But I seen Vivo, so I'm like, all right, it's legit.
And the video was hard, and Jazz got her acting on, and followed by her acting, she got a role for a movie. I'm hyping my girl up. I'm not gonna tell y'all what.
My girl got a role in a movie, y'all. So just stay tuned.
A real movie.
Yeah.
Shout out to real friends. She was hyper. She let you introduce it.
I know, because I'm excited for
her. I'm a little bit nervous, but I'm so.
She's gonna nail it.
I'm so happy to be finally stepping out of my comfort zone. You know what I mean?
Yep.
So this week for me felt good. I feel confident. I feel like I'm growing. When I'm stagnant, I have a really difficult time coping. So I feel refreshed. I feel great this week.
Let's talk about it. Okay. Yes. And my week was pretty good. I worked a lot this week, but you know,
hold up. Shout out to this shit right here. I'm about to tell y'all.
Oh, before I forget, our guy said he got new rings. He showed me them.
Oh,
he said, let your friend know.
I'm pulling up.
Let me tell y'all. Shorty said, me and Shadi got in an argument last night, right? So one, shout out to us for like, because we've been doing a good job at like separating the conversations for real.
Okay.
Even though we got to get to coming back to the conversation, but let's start.
We do a good job at like, you know what? We're not going to argue. It's not going to go nowhere. Let's take a break. We got really good at that.
I like that you started your week off with a joint accomplishment.
Yeah.
You know, it shows that it's y'all are one.
Yeah, yeah. Now let me tell you about this right here.
By myself,
let me tell you, it says,
but I'm a force when with it.
It says, I love you. I apologize. And ready whenever you are ready. I like to talk and work through this. Sade said this.
Who said that?
Sade.
Who stole
this? I said, who this?
Bitch, would you Google how do you be nice to me?
I used to
Google shit like how do I let my nigga know that I don't hate him.
And no, I remember when I was younger, I used to Google shit like how to like. Nah, I ain't gonna say that.
Look, I'm grown and I still Google like.
How would you Google? What was you Googling? Because the first thing that came to my mind is you Googling how to suck dick. That's what you was Googling?
I ain't gonna hold y'all.
When I was younger, I did Google how to ride.
I still haven't figured it out. But the second dick, I did figure it out through Cosmopolitan magazine.
I'm trying to tell you, they have all
the. So they taught you how to ride?
Yo, I'm gonna tell you. But they did they say everything everybody else say, like,
Shorty,
you
wanna ride with me?
They say coconut.
Like coconut, like spell your name.
So you be spelling your name?
That's this how
you
was do old it? Though, but I figured
out because I don't like spelling my name. I don't like the whole, girl, don't grind on my shit.
I felt my own. I figured out my own.
But see, every guy is different. Some guys like up and down action. Some guys like back and forth action.
Yeah, some niggas like the vibrators.
I'm going to tell y'all how we was in here about to have sex. And like, I'm like, I got to take a shower, you know? And Sade is in here watching porn.
Are you on your Kanye? So y'all didn't see that? Wait. Hold up. Did y'all see that? Kenya Moore was on. They asked. Kenya Moore was on some talk show and they asked her what was like a celebrity date that she didn't forget. And she said that she went out with Kanye back in the day. And she said he took her to his house. She was there for like 5 minutes. And she said he was like nowhere to be found. He left her in the room by herself. Then she started wandering around. And when she got to the bedroom, she saw him in there watching porn, like, basically beating his dick, I guess.
Oh, wow.
Like,
wow.
Wait, so whose fault was that, though? Because if...
I don't know if he was trying to get himself started or if he was just on some creep shit.
Yeah, so, Alex, question. You've been having sex recently.
Right, Alex, like,
Do you have to nut one time before you have sex? Because I remember when I was, like, 23, that was a thing.
Nah.
Like, I used to beat out dick, well...
So you don't tap out early.
So
you don't tap out early.
Nah.
Because the second one goes
because you know why? You remember how you were talking about like what weed? I feel like I'm always high. So like,
oh,
for real? Shout out to you. You're still a young man. See me after the first one, I'm done. Like I'm tired.
I ain't gonna hold y'all.
I don't like long sex.
I don't either.
I don't like long sex.
I'd be like, come on. Yeah, I got mine. Let's
come on, baby. I'm right with you. Come on, where we at, man?
Yeah, we getting old.
Yeah.
I think it's like a threshold.
I don't either.
Y'all getting older.
Cause I'm hot. Like,
but then
and then like, don't start hurting me.
Right. Yeah. Like, no.
I want to be comfortable the next day. I don't want to be walking off funny. Like, no.
I feel like the more you're doing in life, it's just like, let's get it done and then go on to our.
But so, I feel like in the moment, like, it's still
I was watching
Kevin Hart special,
yeah.
And he was like, I'm too successful to give you good sex now. It's like, I'm doing
too
much. I mean, I don't know. Kevin Hart's been on his
best bullshit lately. What I will say is, I ain't gonna lie, because I'm very like self-conscious and like competitive at the same time. So I'll be going, after I'm done, I'm still going just because I want to be tapping into my old.
I hate when Jay does that. I feel like, baby.
Nah.
See, I'm a like,
I want to give you.
I like my rounds. So if I wake up in the middle of the night, okay, we can do it again. But we're not about to do it
and then
keep going.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah,
relax.
See, but I'll be just
saying, like, y'all
was
initiated.
I'm older.
Hold up. He said we don't initiate it. Yeah, I don't have any problems.
We already talked
about yes, I do.
We already talked about this.
I don't play the let me scoot up on
you. We definitely, no. I definitely just initiated it. So don't do that.
When you
initiate, how do women initiate sex?
When I was in here watching porn.
You know what? Hold on. How do women initiate sex? Because I want to hear this.
It's ABC. I will pull your dick out, start touching it, and maybe even suck
or
it.
Or I'll be like,
then
I'm trying to have
popping.
Sex.
Come that's here. Not you know that, come here.
And I'll come over there. Stop.
No, I will pull a nigga like,
let me tell you
here.
What Jay does to initiate sex. It's so childish. Jay do this. He'll get behind me. He'll just hump my butt like that and he'll walk off.
That's his.
He'd be like,
his mating signal.
Yeah, it's like, what the fuck is this? Or he'll come grab my titty and then he'd be like, yeah. I'd be like, what does that mean,
you're
dude?
Like
huh? Huh? Are you? And then if I don't move quick enough, he gonna take a work call. I'm like, nigga, fuck you.
Don't. What's not? I don't like that. When you be ready and everything's right, then it's like the move. You be, one little thing. Oh,
he'll
let me pee first. Let me go pee real quick.
It's
and then
like,
it's like, it's, yeah, like damn, my bitch can't pee.
I can't take a shower first. Like goddamn.
Right.
What a shower
about you.
I mean. If it's a quick
like,
shower.
But I feel like just prep
what?
Early.
You come in the shower?
Yeah,
I feel like
prep
prepared.
Early. Like take a shower like 3 hours before. So if you try to have sex 3 hours later, it's already, you don't gotta go
moving.
Stop.
I'm gonna keep it 100. Exactly. I be moving so much that like, I don't really take showers like that. So we about to have sex, I gotta take a shower. Because more than likely, I probably ain't taking a shower.
Nah, I ain't gonna hold you. I ain't gonna hold you. I don't like not taking a shower before
facts.
Because...
I be working.
I'm like one of those
busy.
People who be busy. And it's like, I don't want
any... I'm about to give you sweaty vibes.
I don't want any issues. Yeah, let's just
I
make
need,
it fresh.
I might need the salt intake though, like, you know what I'm saying?
But you know what? I don't like when
shut the fuck up.
I don't like when people feel like
if I'm gonna eat the box, I'm like,
well, I guess
need some seasoning.
That's nasty.
I need some seasoning. Yo.
Well, let me find out. Sade got the Old Bay box.
Like, no, baby, this guy puts tastes like water. Okay.
No, I was gonna say no. I don't like when when people think like when you wake up in the morning for the round two, you gotta take a shower. Like, nigga, we're already
I ain't lie, but that morning but sex be good because like the pussy marinate.
See,
like,
I overnight. Hate morning sex, like, yo, but I'm with the
morning
shit.
You wake up, you don't, the pussy be already just serenading.
It's like it was in a crock pot.
Yeah, it's like it was in a crock pot for 24 hours, like 12 hours. Like, oh my God, that should be.
You know what?
And your crock ass better have been
what are you doing right now? What's going on?
That should be sweet.
Crock pot.
That's called an audible.
Audible. No, I'm with Alex, but that's, we wasn't doing that, but it makes sense, bro. It makes sense.
I'm like a kid in school that's like feeling slighted. I'm like, no, let's talk about something that we all get to do.
Look, I'm not having sex.
Yeah, so I don't
want to
talk about it no
Jasmine
more.
Jasmine Alex celibate, so I don't know what that means.
Facts,
Alex,
there you go.
That's Jasmine
Alex celibate. I was Alex type celibate. Nah, I ain't gonna hold you. I was Alex type celibate last week. This week, y'all, I'm just celibate. I might even be just
wait, what that means?
Abstinent. So
what
was
last what changed? What changed?
Vibes, time.
Wait. Boyfriend?
Huh? It's hot in here. I gotta go. Like, no, no, but what are you talking about? I never had a boyfriend.
Okay, it's okay.
Nah, hey, you talking about the boy?
Yeah, the guy.
Oh, so you know, honestly,
it made me wanna throw my pager out the window. Call
and no, this was literally me. I was listening to Bugaboo in the car, and I was like this by the end of the song. And my daughter said, "Ma, you good?" I said,
"I got a Bugaboo on my hand." Baby.
I said, yeah.
It's cool.
I
Alex, just take us out, bro. What we talking about, man? It's fine. Just take us out. No,
but honestly, he's a nice guy. It didn't work because of me. And I think
it's not me. It's not you as me.
Yeah, I think he understands that now.
You are, it's not you as me ass nigga.
I am. If it's really not.
Does that actually work? Like it's not you. I'm just trying to tell you.
So,
I just
so I'm going to be real with y'all. I didn't say anything. He just started kind of ignoring him. I ghosted him.
Wow.
Yeah, I did.
What?
Hold on. Can we normalize ghosting?
No, why would we normalize that?
And I don't mean like normalize it in that way, but like if I express to you what I need and you don't give it to me, can we normalize ghosting and it be okay?
No, just express that you ain't giving me what I need.
But if I already said that, can we normalize ghosting?
It's not that I needed to express what I needed. It's just that I didn't want it from him and it had nothing to do with him as a person. He's a great guy, but I definitely ghosted him, and I do feel like a coward.
That's
but
a great segue.
So you know what's
though.
Interesting?
That's I also feel like I didn't perfect. Owe him to
that's
not.
A great segue
to the first topic, actually.
Yes. Okay.
We're talking about requirements.
Oh, okay.
And like, what are your
what exactly was it, Alex?
What are your requirements?
Yeah,
like
because
each individual
what was it?
Requirements.
No, nah, it's fine. This is actually his okay. job. This is actually Alex's job. So
okay.
He had it easy because we had help. So like, let
okay,
him do his job.
Okay. But I got you.
What are your requirements? Like each and every one of his requirements. And was there ever an experience where you felt like your requirements weren't met? And how did you go about that? I mean, you just give an example, but
so you mean in as far as dating or like in a relationship? Mm-hmm, dating.
As far as dating.
Okay, so
or
my
in life. I mean, dating, relationship. What do you require? To be the best Jasmine, do you feel like you require?
Okay, so.
And everybody else.
All right. So before I say what it is that I require, I am one of those people who you could give me everything I require. And if I don't want it from you, then I can't accept it, you know? And then it's time to move forward. But my requirements would be. When it comes to me, like what you're giving me, not what you are as a person, I need support. Mm. And I don't mean financial support. Like I need support as far as like building up my confidence so that I can believe that I can obtain and achieve the things that I have set forth to do. And I want you to support me. Mm-hmm. In a sense of checking on it, mm-hmm. Bigging me up, you know, or constructive criticism. That's all support, you know, clap when I win, you mm-hmm. know, cheer mm-hmm. for me.
Mm-hmm. How does that look though? Because I feel like a lot of times we have these requirements, but we don't really know how it looks. So this one thing that you said that stood out when you was like, clap for me.
Mm-hmm.
How does clapping for you look?
Clapping for me is positive reinforcement when you see that I'm trying to do something that is important to me or that I excel at something that's important to me. So I want it to be a situation where, you know, when I'm about to go, say I'm about to go do an audition, mm-hmm. I need my man to be like, man, you got this. Like, they crazy if they don't pick you. Like, come on, like, practice it with me. Like, that's, you know what I'm saying? And like then affirmations. And then when I actually get it, I need him to be like, let's celebrate. You know what I'm saying? Or I need him to be like more turned on by me because I succeeded at something.
Mm-hmm. So let me ask you this though, because I think this can help relationships as well. What if you do something that, this is going to sound terrible.
Go ahead.
What if you do something that the other, the person that you're dating or you're with don't
approve of?
Not approve of, but don't really think that's
okay,
something
so
major. And he might not saying he don't want to, but he wouldn't know to because to him, that's regular. Not saying a movie.
So
like
I don't
that.
Think that, I think that as grown adults, I think that's not being true to reality because you know, as an adult, you know, what's an accomplishment for another person. It doesn't have to be your greatest accomplishment, but to what they're doing, you know that was an accomplishment for them. So you shouldn't be comparing your achievements to somebody else's and being like, well, why would I applaud you for that? Like, everybody does that. Yeah, no, or it's not a big deal. Yeah, but I know that for you, that was an accomplishment. Oh, so let me clap.
Time out. I'm sorry. Can we rewind for a second? Because how can you say that and in the same token say that I'm not going to praise a guy for not cheating because that's what you're supposed to do? So my question kind of is, like, some things I might think is what you're supposed to do, right? So mm-hmm. Like you said, I feel like we can sum that up with like knowing your partner. And I feel like a lot of times we don't pay attention. And it's not intentionally. You know mm-hmm. what I'm saying? Because I feel like Sade, I use this because I feel like Sade has came to me and said, like, I'm a hater or like I don't.
I felt that way from some of my guys.
But I don't think that is me being a hater. It's just like you can say, you know, being faithful is that's what you're supposed to do. So I'm not going to applaud
that. I think really quickly before you chime mm-hmm. in, I think that the difference between someone not knowing that mm-hmm. something is an accomplishment to you and someone being a hater is mm-hmm. how do you cheer for other people mm-hmm. that do smaller things than you?
Okay.
Louder than you cheer for me when I do something.
So mm-hmm. should I?
You touch on that. Go ahead, and I also think that something we're talking about now is stating that is a requirement because just like she's saying, well, this is a requirement for me. If we normalize going in two things and saying like this is what I require, then we know to do it. And I think something that we all equally said in the last podcast was you have to say that's what you require.
No, you're right.
So I think it's the difference of stating that's what you require and then giving it, because again, a lot of guys don't get praised for being faithful because they're also not coming out like and saying that's a struggle for me to be faithful. Can you cheer for me for that? So now that we're here and we're talking about requirements, I think it's something that is possible as long as that's being stated. So she's stating that, you know, I require this. So yeah, if I state that and you're not doing it, it's different. But if you never state it and expect me to do it, I think that's a big difference.
So do you think, honestly, both of y'all for real, do y'all think that y'all going to, and all of us, honestly, do we go into our relationship saying, all right, this is a requirement for me, or we just expect it?
I'm guilty of both.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm guilty of both.
The older I get, the more I'm able to express uh-huh. no or yes.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Sometimes I am so much in my own head that
you expecting it and not saying nothing.
Exactly, or I'm basing it off of what I'm giving out.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a great
yeah.
point.
Yeah.
Shade, it's been times where you told me that you don't think that, and not just being a hater, because that's probably just bad wording.
Right, right,
you know
right.
what I'm saying? But you said that, but you might didn't mean that. It's been times where you actually felt like I didn't cheer for you when you wanted me to cheer for you.
Yeah.
What was that example of?
Just like, you know, just like little, like, so I'm big on, I celebrate my small wins. Mm-hmm. And I know that a lot of people, you know, some people don't really care about the small wins. They care about only the big achievements. But I'm a person who everything I do is
that's
a goal.
Better than what you did.
Exactly. Right. So every elevation, even if it's in the smallest form, I'm like, I pushed through that. So, you know, and just a little backstory, I think I've expressed to Jay, like before, just in us talking about our history with our parents, you know, I didn't have parents that would say things like, I'm proud of you. So like, that was something big for me, even being with a significant other, because obviously you're major in my life and I want to hear that. Like, mm-hmm. I'm proud of you. Like, even if you don't think it's a big deal, it's, you know, and what I will say,
yeah,
that,
recognize how I feel about it.
Exactly. Mm. So like, for example, you know, for example, like I was trying to work on an app like 2 years ago. And it's a lot of work, you know what I'm saying? But it was my first time getting into it. You know, I didn't know all the requirements, and but I was still pushing forward. I was still going to taking the meetings. Initiative. I was still taking the initiative, and I was still having these meetings. I was meeting with the developer. I was doing these things. For me, somebody, you know, again, coming from my history of the things I've been through,
that's a big
deal for me to even have that in my conversation. You know what I mean? And I think that, you know, Jay had a lot of achievements that he already have done at that time. You get what I'm saying? On his entrepreneurship endeavor. At that time, I'm just new to entrepreneurship. I'm just trying to step out there. And I, at that point, I think I was voicing him. I didn't feel like, because I was in the process, because it wasn't done, I told him, like, it's like he wouldn't have clapped until it was complete.
Right.
Like, you know what I'm saying? And again, because I'm big on celebrating my small wins, that was the time I'm like, you know, I was like, damn, like, you know what I'm saying? I'm trying, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, be proud that I'm trying, be proud that I'm even making these steps. And it's not like you got to be like, oh, you like, oh my God, like you doing that, baby. But I do kind of would like, you know what I'm saying? Like, damn, babe, you know, I see you, like, you know what I'm saying?
Goes both ways.
And I was about to go into that.
You know, when somebody is more accomplished than you,
yeah,
you sometimes don't clap for their small things because you're like, that's nothing to them. Bro. Like, I'm not going to clap for it. But it might mean something
but
to
them. But not even that, right? And I was going to say it goes both ways because, like, Sade is actually somebody that introduced me to, like, appreciating your small wins, right? So that goes to show that I was never into even acknowledging my own small wins. So if I'm not acknowledging my own small wins, I'm not about to acknowledge yours. It's not intentional.
Yeah, it's just what I'm used to, right?
Yeah. So what I was going to say is it goes into, one, knowing your partner on my end. Right, because I don't think Shadi had never came to me like, yo, I need you to appreciate my small wins, right? Well, I need you to clap for my small wins. And so because she never did that, I didn't know. But however, same thing we want as men, right? And like we said, we figured this out from last week, and we said, yo, we gotta be able to communicate what we want, right? Mm-hmm. However, also, just like, I want you to praise me for being faithful or whatever the case may be, because I want you to just know, even though I didn't say it, I should almost give you the same thing, right? I should just, if I'm gonna say that about that, I should be able to be like, okay, she's clearly somebody that wants to be appreciated for her small wins, and I should know that. But at the same time, just like I can hold myself accountable, we gotta hold each other accountable. You gotta hold yourself accountable, saying, like, you know what? I should have made that clear, right?
Yeah.
But, like, okay, I'll say this though. I think it really is also contingent on the person, because, like you said, that wasn't something that you did even for yourself. So you didn't intentionally not clap for her. It's just that you weren't clapping at all,
right?
For anyone. But I feel like that's where compatibility and work comes in, because, like, recently I did, like, some small video project, and one of my friends, male friends, was like, I was like, yeah, I gotta go out here for just a day, like, gotta get this shit done real quick, woo woo. And he was like, okay, like, well, damn, that shit sucks, but, like, you know, do what you gotta do. And then my other friend, he was like, cause you did that. And I was like, it wasn't nothing. He was like, man, anything you were part of is something. Like, what you talking about? And it's like, damn, that's what I really wanted to hear.
And another thing is, we gotta stop, like, looking at other people in their actions, right? Because we don't know. For example, like, again, and this is just real life shit with me and Sade. Like, it's been times where Sade will see me, and not, like, even to this day, you know what I'm saying? Sade sees me, like, applaud other people, right?
Mm-hmm.
And she'll look at that, and she'll look at how I treat her when it comes to her wins or what she thinks is victories, and I might not see it, right?
Mm-hmm.
But what she don't understand, or what we don't understand, is I've been seeing these people for years before I met you.
Okay.
So it might look like I'm applauding them just to be applauding them,
but you don't know
I've seen these people grind from nothing to this. So it's like, yo, shout out, this nigga is lit, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, it's normal, like, yo, I'm your partner, I want that same energy,
right?
But I just feel like when we compare, they, like, it's real when we say comparison is a thief of joy, because it's like, all right, I see how you treating other people, I want to be treated like that. But I think it boils down to communicating what we want.
But I, you know what, I think that it always your partner should be your number one fan.
And I agree. And I, you know, and just, you know, for some accountability on my end too, I just think that, you know, a lot of times we, like, for example, like, you know, like, me and Jazz are friends. Like, anything Jazz do, I'm like, bitch, nah, it's up. But, you know, I think subconsciously, that's what I want. Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, I want a friend that's always like, and, you know, me and Jazz do it to each other, but like subconsciously, I think we do it because it's like, yeah, like big up your friends, big up your partner.
But you know, that, big up, you know what I'm saying? That's very important though, yeah. Because, you know, you doing that makes me feel comfortable to succeed, because I know it sounds crazy, but some people get uncomfortable with yeah. success because they've yeah. been told so long, or yeah. they've seen too many signs that they don't deserve
yeah.
that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And it's very important when your friends remind you
yeah.
that they're proud of you and you do deserve it, because the whole world could think something, right? Yeah. And you don't care about it. Uh-huh. But when the people that you care about right. let you know that they're proud of you, yeah. it means so much more. Yeah. And that's what keeps you going.
Yeah. So is that something that you think is a requirement of yours?
Yeah, I think a requirement for me is definitely the support. And you know, just like I said, giving that background of where I come from, that's huge for me. Just having somebody just, yeah, yeah. And like, you know, just to... You know, and that might be my inner child that I'm talking to, but it's no different. I compare it to how my daughter is. Like, sometimes I don't, you know what I'm saying? Like, it's your daughter. It's like, you know, you were supposed to do that. But it's like, I'm proud of you, babe. Like, I tell my daughter I'm proud of her a lot.
Me too.
Because, like,
you know what it's like to not be told
all the time. But I also feel like it's a push that helps her continue. You know, mommy, she's proud of me. So, you know what I'm saying? Like,
when you amp somebody up, yeah, they go harder.
They go harder. Like, you know what I'm saying?
Go ahead, Alex.
I was going to say, like, adding on to the requirements, because it's everything that y'all are saying kind of, like, was interesting because, for example, like, my father, right? Never said I love you to us,
right?
He was always somebody that showed it. He was yeah. never somebody that said it. And yeah. I remember actually on Thanksgiving, which was recent, it was mm-hmm. recently, he told my niece, he was on the phone with her, and he was like, yeah, you know, I love you, can't wait to see
he
you.
He probably was looking like,
and it wasn't me in yeah. particular, but like even her mother, because yeah. you know, we're all around and we just looked at each other. It was like, did he just yeah. say that? You know, yeah. like we never heard such yeah. a thing. So it's just interesting to see, like, and it's something that she clearly required. You know, sometimes you want to yeah. hear I'm proud of you and all these things, but it's like, I feel like certain times in our lives, we don't learn it with the yeah. person that's right next to us and yeah. the person that's supposed to go to.
Right.
So then it skips to the next person gonna, yeah. as you grow and you start to realize, yeah. all right,
I was
going to
go into that because
so
like, true. I feel like my mom's, we got to get the phones to work, because I was going to call my mom. So my mom's don't, she don't believe in like saying I'm proud of somebody. And I feel like that came from me, but it wasn't like a negative thing. It was just like, yo, I'm happy for you. You know what I'm saying? I'm not yes. proud of you. You know what I'm saying?
Because
like,
I know I expected that of you.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, I'm happy for you. And that's how I carried it. And
but essentially, I think it's the same thing. Like, yeah, if you didn't say I'm proud of you, but you're like, yo, I'm
but
happy
you know
for
what?
You. I love what you're doing.
Not,
I feel the same.
No, but I
got
to be honest. It's not the yeah. same, because mm-hmm. the way you just described it is funny, because my parents are literally both of those. So my mother is the I'm proud of you, and mm-hmm. my father is the okay, sweetie, I'm happy for you.
Yeah.
But honestly, it hits harder to hear proud.
Yeah. Right.
Because that means like I accomplished. Happy yeah. for me means like I'm happy you're happy.
Right.
But it's like it doesn't reinforce success in that I grew. It's
I
just
agree.
Like, okay.
So for me, before we look it up, y'all know we the podcast of Google and definition.
Definition J.
So before we look it up, right? So for me, when I came up being proud meant like, you know, my mom was like, yo, I don't want to twist my words up, but for me, it was like, yo, if I'm proud of you, that means I had something to do with it, or like, I don't know. It's hard to explain, but it's like, I'm not proud of you because like, that was you. That was all you. You know what I'm saying? Like, who am I to be proud of you? You know what I'm saying? Like, what did I do for you to like, to make me proud of you? I'm not
but
proud of
like
you.
I feel like proud is a feeling, and I don't think it has to be like, you have to be attached to somebody to be proud of them.
Yeah.
I think it's more so a feeling of just like appreciation and joy for the person of what they accomplished.
Yes.
Like Jazz said, not necessarily of
how they feel
how
about
they
their
feel
accomplishment.
About their accomplishment. There we go.
I think, hold up, sorry. Get out the burner.
So I think, damn, that's why we gotta get a phone call.
Like,
I wanted to ask my mom.
I actually, okay, so if you wanna go an example of my friendship with Sade.
Push it.
She'll say, like, if I like a guy a lot and mm-hmm. he's making me happy, she'll say, okay, Stink, I'm happy for you. But if I do something in my career that is a step, she'll be like, nah, for real, dog, I'm proud of you.
Yeah.
Cause not many people yeah. can say woo woo woo. And I think that's the difference right there.
Right.
Like, you're
right.
not proud of me for getting a man, because
right.
that's not something
right.
that's
so
an
I'm
accomplishment.
Happy for you.
You're happy for me,
but
because
you,
it's an emotion
right.
that
okay.
I'm, but when I succeed in something in my career,
yeah.
now you're proud of
right.
me, because
and,
now
right.
I'm making
yeah.
a success.
Exactly.
I think
like
one of my,
me,
go ahead, bro.
But I feel like for me, it's like my parents are happy when it's something that's unexpected. You know what I mean? Like something happens that's good, that's unexpected. It's like, all right, cool. But they're proud when I set a goal, I let them know the goal. And it's like, you accomplished this. You know what I mean? You said you were going to do something and you did it.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's showing that you're holding yourself accountable. We didn't have to tell you to do it. Like you wanted this bad enough that you went out and made it happen.
So what's the next expectation for you in going into a relationship?
Requirement or expectation? Or
grace.
A requirement. Like, what do you require this to do?
For requirement, it's just grace and patience. Like, that's the biggest thing for me. And the reason why I say grace is because I'm not perfect. And I know that, you know, and like, I remember seeing somewhere that like, you have to accept that the good, that you're good and you're bad, you know, and a lot of times you don't, a lot of people just see the good in themselves and it's like, and I just need somebody to, I just require somebody to see that. It's like, I'm a work in progress.
Why do you feel like you require that?
Why? Just because I felt like I didn't get that a lot growing up, you know, and I didn't get it from like, not from people that were close to me, but like professionals, school. Right. And then, you know, at a time you start to feel like it's you, you know, you internalize the doubt that people cast on you at times like that because they're unable to see the greatness within you. Right. So when you find somebody that can see, like, you're just flawed, this is just a season, you know, it kind of encourages you because I remember seeing a post that was like, you have to amp up your friends. You know what I mean? Because when you amp up your friends and you gas them up, you tell them that they're proud, they can accomplish things that they wouldn't have imagined.
Yeah. It unlocks something else in somebody. Them, a higher level. But I want to ask y'all something because since you guys, well, Jay, first I want to hear what you require, but I also, when you finish, I want to know, because you guys are both here and in a relationship, do you ever feel like one person requires more than the other?
So I actually was going to get into that conversation. Mm-hmm. This is going to be more fun than that question. That was cute.
I was going to go left.
Huh? Relax.
We're going to get into it.
Because he's ready.
So I don't think I have a requirement because it changes, right? Like, even like, damn, I can't wait till we really have these conversations. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But, you know, like, it's things that we require that change. You know what I'm saying? Because we understand.
Because you're growing.
You know what I'm saying?
Hold up. Because is it because you understand or is it because
you've grown?
You've got hurt by something in the past and now this is a requirement because it fucked me up last time.
It's not that. Nah. So I'm really kind of talking from like both of our perspective, honestly, right? Because you can have a requirement. Somebody don't meet your requirement and it's like, you know what?
A disappointment. We're human.
Yeah, right. And I can be disappointed, but I can still move past it. Right? So I don't think it's a requirement. Because when I look at somebody
can do something that you don't like. And now for your next, like say your girlfriend cheated on you, right? Mm-hmm. And say she worked at night. Now you might have a requirement that your girlfriend has to work during the day.
So that's where I'm going. Mm-hmm. Honestly, like, I mean, since we having the conversation, it's kind of like that, right? So you might have a requirement that your man don't cheat on you. Your man cheat on you and it's like, damn. So I look at requirements like—
Is that a
requirement? So I look at, this is how I, and again, we can pull this up the definition because I don't know if it's correct or not from the terminology, but my when I look at requirement, I look at, you know, ain't no ifs, ands, or buts going around this. That's why I say I don't have any requirements when it comes to relationship because it can change at any moment. You know what I'm saying? Okay. And if we really love each other, something that changed, I might not agree with it. Shit, we might go out separate ways for a couple seconds and not separate ways like break up, but we might, you know what I'm saying? We might even argue and not be cool for a couple weeks, shit, even a month or two, you know what I'm saying? But it's not a requirement for me because I'm not going to leave you because I love you. You know what I'm saying? For what I expect, though, and I think this way it goes wrong.
Expectations
I
have and requirements are two different things.
But that's why I said this is why I'm being transparent. This is why it might go wrong. Me, I want fairness and I want respect, right? However, I have to understand that fairness and respect is so subjective.
Right.
Like what respect looks like to me.
Are you settling for less than what you think respect is, and
that's why I say I don't have no requirements because of course I am. Like in my relationship, of course I am because we have to learn each other, right? So yeah, I can't. So it's gonna what I'm gonna say is gonna sound like a contradiction, but it's not, right?
Wait, let me simplify it for you. So if you have a girlfriend, right, and you love her, and you love getting head, right?
Mm-hmm.
Are you going to be able to be with someone who does not give you head?
So again, it's because of love, right? Like it's different. Like, so
you say you have no requirements, but the definition
of requirements is a thing that is needed or wanted. See, for me, the definition doesn't make sense because like needed or wanted.
The second definition is better. A thing that is compulsory, a necessary condition.
Okay, cool. So that's why I say I don't have any requirements because like
I might deem it being necessary, and then it happened, and I see how unnecessary it is. Like, so, how not necessary
so,
it is.
So, okay, so let's
but
go
that comes
to the,
through the experience.
No, let's go to the real life question at hand. So, say Sade doesn't give head.
Mm-hmm.
Can you stay with her?
Like, even not even that, right? Because let's just be real.
No,
like,
can you stay with her?
No, let's be real. And real
why?
So
I think
feel like,
it's the why.
So though, I require respect. I require fairness.
Mm-hmm.
I've been preaching fairness in my relationship for 3 years, right?
Mm-hmm.
However, it's not really a requirement, because if I was really required it, I would have left. You get what I'm trying to say?
For that, but that's an emotional requirement. People have physical requirements right. as well.
So I feel like a requirement is a requirement, though. If we're gonna act, if it's a requirement, if you require
you had,
it,
but
if
no,
you need
you,
it.
You said you had none, so you don't require that your
but
girlfriend give
I
you
want.
Head.
That's what I want. And if I didn't want it as much, I speak about it a lot.
So you'd be okay with it if she didn't?
No, it's not. I'm not okay with it being unfair.
But would
and
you
this,
leave her if she didn't?
And no.
Okay, so
and I
not
say that because, again, some things build up. I can't speak for all. Like, life isn't just black and white, like you say. Like, you know what I'm saying, like, right. black and white is computers. The gray area makes us human. So I feel like when it comes to requirements, like, my requirements change over time. Like, yeah, I want respect. Yeah, I want fairness. However, I have to be patient enough for you to understand what my respect look like. I got to be patient
yes,
enough for you to understand
agree.
What my fairness looks like, because
I agree.
Yeah, 3 years right. is a long time. However, it's not nowhere near yeah. a long
but,
time.
And
but
I also think like,
are you know, patient mm-hmm. or do you just not require it? Because if she never does it, then what?
So of course, so me, I would like to think I'm patient. However, even life is about perspective, right?
Yeah.
So like for me, I'm patient because I'm staying.
Mm-hmm.
For her, I might be impatient because I'm always saying something about it. Mm-hmm. You get what I'm saying? So it's really about perspective. So like we can have this conversation right
but
now.
But like say you get married, right? And nothing changes. It's been 10 years. Are you going to get fed up and
so,
walk away and that's
so
a divorce?
We can't speak on that because I don't know. And that's why I keep keeping it here and I'm trying to be as transparent as possible, right? It's so like 3 years, I've been asking for the same thing. And it's some things that Sade been asking for the same thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, and it's some things that she required that I fell short on, to be honest. You get like just to be completely 100%.
Of course, everybody falls short of requirements because we're human, you know? Mm-hmm. And it's sometimes... That's why I asked. Is to this one of y'all have do one of y'all have more requirements? Because sometimes, like I've dated people where I'm like, look,
so
I can't even meet your requirements.
Look at this though.
Yeah.
Think about this. I don't think I have a lot of requirements. It's just when it comes to perspective, right? I said my requirements is respect and fairness. Mm-hmm. But guess what? Those are so broad that mm-hmm. respect can look like so disrespect
right.
can look like so many different
and,
things.
Yeah.
Different
right, right,
and just
right.
to touch on like, you know, just the like for example, his levels of disrespect and my levels of disrespect are
totally
different. Like so something I deem as disrespect, he probably like I didn't even know that was disrespectful. Vice versa. He might be like, nah, you like it's been times in our relationship where Jay's like, nah, you disrespected me. And I'm like, how? That ain't disrespect. You know what I'm saying?
I was
but
saying
it's subjective because that's his form of disrespect. What's disrespect is my form of disrespect. Now, do I think like there's some things that are just not
yeah, I was gonna say some shit.
Me,
just
yeah,
disrespectful.
Me no, me, yeah. yes. But like he's never done anything where I can even in the moment I'm like, nah, you disrespectful. But can I say it's just like some things I'm not negotiating on disrespect. You get what I'm
so,
saying? Like,
okay, it might be disrespectful. It's just not unforgivable.
Okay,
but not.
That's,
but
that's
not
good.
Even.
That's
but
that's
but
good.
I don't
that's
even
good.
Believe. I don't think that because there's been times where we got isn't got really heated and it's things that I just wouldn't be okay with. But given the circumstances, not that I'm okay, that I understand and I it's like okay, mm-hmm. you know, I don't accept this. However, I have to. I can't ignore the role that I played
yeah.
in it. And a lot of times, that's why I think honestly. The biggest thing of it all, I hate to keep coming to this because I feel like in that whole 50,
yeah.
damn, what episode is it? 49 episodes
yeah.
that we've been talking about communication, right?
Yeah.
So it's like, it's been times where things went left and it's been times where things went left and I played a role in it, but I didn't understand the role that
yeah.
I played.
Okay, so, all right.
Yeah.
Okay, so I feel like this is the perfect jump because we're saying right now, like, things that we wanted.
It's subjective.
Right? But hold on. But is there a such thing as creating a boundary as a prerequisites?
I don't think
so. That somebody can't even get close enough to you until
to
they
we
show
can,
you that they do what you require.
We can
it's
create the we can create the boundary, but at the same time, like Alex said, right? And it's another thing that Sade has like show me in our relationship grace, right? So like it goes back to grace because you can create that boundary, but again, you're bound just because you have a boundary coming into a relationship or any situation or any relationship, not even just emotional. I mean, not emotional. Romantic relationship, right? Any relationship that you go into, you're gonna have your boundaries.
Okay,
however, because we're different, you can't expect me to just follow your boundaries off the top.
Okay, so I'll say this. You have no requirements, right? That's what you said.
But I have once.
But do you have any boundaries?
So again, absolutely. I have, and even that, I'm gonna say no, because to me, when I'm not being truthful,
I'll tell you how I know.
You do.
Hold on,
no.
Stop. Yeah, he does. I'm gonna tell you a real life example.
Go ahead.
I remember Sade expressing that she wanted you to share your location, and you were like, no, that's.
I never said that.
Yes.
Wrong person.
Did he? No, it's the right person.
No, wrong person.
He said he wasn't sharing his
wrong
location.
Wrong relationship.
I don't know if you were capping or what.
No, wrong relationship.
I only know a couple of motherfuckers in relationships.
It was a wrong relationship, I'm sorry.
Nah, it was you. You were like, I'm not sharing my location.
I never said that. We were joking. I'm about to say, because that was like, that's wrong. I'm sorry.
Okay, because he said it.
Yeah, no, but it was a joke. Okay, I'm sorry. You know you like to play devil's advocate.
Okay,
I'm like, you said you're not sharing your location.
I'm just saying, because like, nah, that's not.
Nah, because you remember. He was like, you didn't share your location. He was like, nah, I don't share my location.
He was playing a devil's advocate, trying to, you know.
So what I'm going to say is, for example, right? I say I don't have any because it just always changes. Like, we spoke about this before, so I guess we got this conversation. So, like, when it comes to, like...
But let's be real. When you like somebody, man, everything changes.
But no,
that's real.
Even that is, like, it's not even about liking somebody. It's, like, the boundaries just, it changed because when you, as we get older, we understand
they get
different
stretched.
Things. It's not even that, though. Like, for example, I can say my boundaries is don't put your hands on me, right?
Okay.
But guess what else I didn't take in account of that? The part that I played in it. You know what I'm saying?
Hold up. But regardless, if you get hands put on you... In that moment, you are not okay with that.
So it's a boundary. Let's not get it fucked up.
It's a boundary.
The conversation that we're having is just a grown-up conversation.
People cross boundaries.
No, hold up. Right.
Right.
Yeah.
And that's real.
Wait, I'm just saying the conversation that we're having is a grown-up conversation. However, it ain't for the audience out there. It's easier said than done. Let's not get it fucked up.
Of course.
I'm not.
Yeah.
Let's not get it fucked up. All I'm saying is looking at it for perspective and being transparent, like you can have a requirement of nobody's gonna put their hands on me, et cetera, et cetera. And, well. Woman, because we're going, it's just a double standard. We're going to have sex. A woman is not going
huh?
to,
nah,
I'm,
nah,
but
we,
not,
we,
not,
we don't, we agree
is,
that applies
I'm
on
say,
both sides.
It does,
we
it
do.
Does. But
yeah,
however,
we do.
It's more understandable. It is what it is. It's more understandable for a woman to put her hands on a man. It is what it is. I'm not accepting no man.
It's not right, though.
It's not.
You just said, I'm not accepting. So there you go.
I'm not with a nigga. I said, I'm not accepting a man put his hand on a woman at all.
Period.
Right.
I'm not. I'm sorry. That's a double standard.
Okay. But what if you get in a position where you guys get into it and you end up putting your hands on her?
Okay. So then what?
So that's a... something for me, and that's why. And again,
but that's still one of your requirements.
It's a requirement for me, and I say that right. I'm glad you had this conversation. So the hands is a requirement for me because I know I could never do that. That's why it's a requirement for me. However, what we don't take in consideration is the part that I played in it. So even if Shadi was to put her hands on me,
like
I didn't.
How did you trigger it?
Exactly, and I feel like as humans, we gotta understand that. So like, let's not get it fucked up. Yeah, my requirement is you don't put your hands on me because I can't put my hands on you.
So y'all,
the words that I said could have been a punch.
I'm not saying you beat her ass. I know you would never.
But sometimes words feel just like.
But hold up, y'all have never gotten physical in an argument.
But that's why I'm having this conversation. What I don't fuck with is a woman would be like, you put your hands on me. Like if I grab you and like try, like shut up, like
you were aggressive. You were too aggressive.
It's like, whoa.
You hit me. What?
I'm like, wait. But it's a force. You put your hands on me. Like, whoa.
It's the language. It's the language.
Your fingerprints are in.
You're controlling the narrative at this point. Like you shifted the narrative.
Now, if somebody's like, oh, he beat my ass. Okay, you didn't get your ass beat. But no, he put his hands on me. You once you touch her in a.
And I hate that though.
What if you come at me with a knife and I stiff arm
once you touch somebody the way they don't want to be touched, you have now put your hands on them.
Though, you were coming.
That's
you
so
had
bad.
A knife.
You know what's funny? I just want to say, how Jazz said in the last episode, how she broke that glass and the nigga was like, you cut my neck.
Yeah.
Niggas do that shit too.
It's
like, nigga, like I walk and bump me. You're like, no, because you just bumped me. You just did the most. Like,
I don't think I've done that.
I don't think I've done that. You don't think?
Has he done it, Sade? You would be the best person to know.
I think you may have been in conversation, y'all might have been into it,
and I might have been playing peacemaker, and I think he might have been like, but did she tell you she put her hands on me? Did she tell you she put her hands on me? Then I come back to her, I'm like, bro, you hit him? She like,
Shade will punch a nigga and be like, I mean, I ain't hit you hard. Like, nigga, punch this shit out of me. Fuck you mean?
Nah, because snatching my wig off is the fucking same thing. Fuck is you talking about?
Yes.
Fuck is you talking about?
You got your wig snatched. I did. Literally. But
yeah, I'm going to talk about it on the live podcast because I'm still mad.
But hold on. Let's be clear.
How did we get
it's
here?
It's never okay. Nah, it's never okay to physically violate.
Never.
And I feel like everyone should have that boundary. Right, not right, physical. Right,
right, right. What I was trying to say is, you know, like, far as that situation, right? Like, a woman putting, or in that situation, yeah, I might have a requirement of a woman never to put their hands on me, right? Because I can't put my hands on you. So that's a requirement for me. However, once you get into a relationship and you get old and you get more mature, you understand that, you know what? Okay, let me not just say what my requirements is. If I'm going to have a requirement, I have to understand the part that I'm playing in it. Mm-hmm. For my requirement, okay. For example, mm-hmm. Like, so Sade has, I don't know, one time she's been in some situations that are very sensitive, right? Mm-hmm. And very dear, and we'll get into them in conversations mm-hmm. later. But that's not my job to bring those up mm-hmm. in arguments. You know what I'm saying? That's a trigger. So if she snaps from that, it don't make it okay. And that's when it results in. But that's why I'm saying I don't have requirements, because we have to look at ourselves. What do you require from yourself?
Okay, so hold up.
Is it okay to? I feel like it's okay to have requirements, but have the understanding if a requirement is broken. Yeah, that's or something
but no. Like. I'm not but see, I think like we're confusing. I think we're confusing requirements and with boundaries.
Right. I do too.
This is why I love myself. I'm Kanye West. I'm on a little. I didn't say that.
Fanboy.
That was wild. I'm getting my Kanye West on. So like, I love myself because like
Gemini.
Nah, you said it. It's on tape. We got it.
I know that was gay.
Hey, listen, wait.
I'm the Yellow Power
Hold on.
Ranger.
Can I just say shout out to my He's Brandy because I'm drunk again.
Yo, it sneaks up quick.
I'm drunk again.
I gotta teach y'all something. We're gonna pause when we go into the next one. We're gonna shout them out, but let's shout them out right now.
But
shout
no,
out
to my but I gotta keep it real. I'm drunk.
Yeah, shout out to my shout out to my He's Brandy, MAHEES Black owned DMV. Make sure you shout them out because they got a smiz, a little
every
more than
time.
Smiz. I only had one cup.
Every time
I'm drunk,
it sneaks Facts. Up.
But let me. So what I was saying,
Step
is, right?
Back.
So
shout
I
out
say,
to the bartender.
I, say, like, I was saying I love me because you know how y'all get y'all boundaries, and then when I got to me, I'm giving my point, and everybody disagree. But anyway. What I'm
Ooh,
saying is,
no, because no, okay, so, I'll do you one better. Y'all are both here today.
Yes.
How long have y'all been in a relationship?
Going on 3 years.
Almost
okay.
3 years.
Now, in the first 3 months that you met this man, mm-hmm. was there anything that you had to compromise in order to get to the next? Don't say anything. I'm asking her.
Go ahead.
In order to get to the next step with him, did he have any boundaries? Because requirements are once you enter something and now you require that. But did he have anything that was set in place from the beginning that you felt like you could not do because you knew it would push him away? He may not have said it, but you recognized it and you didn't go there because not you knew
well,
it was a boundary.
No, he didn't have boundaries, but he did express like he doesn't really like when women start to get too like too mad. He don't really he'll leave, he'll call the cops, he'll walk in. But that was something from the beginning.
That's a boundary. I'm gonna call the cops if you start tripping.
Yeah, like, cause you know, he's had his fair share even prior to me. Like, he just like, I don't fuck with that.
Not
like,
me, I would never call the cops. But yo, hey, I don't fuck with them people.
Y'all can have court in the street.
You want to get
for
punched?
Real.
You want to get
punched?
You want to get punched by my
court,
father?
Two defendants. No plaintiff.
I'm calling cops unless you want me to knock you the fuck out.
But when I'm
knocking
you out, baby, you can get shot at tonight.
You going to sleep.
She tripping.
Yeah. Hey, 911.
Nah, but come save her.
You gotta say that. I'm calling you first. Because...
Nah, but like, hey, but hold up. You ever been in a position where you call them first and they still come up and arrest you? You the aggressor now, baby. It don't matter who called this.
What I was,
you look aggressive.
A lot of times I've gotten a position where I called the cops and I almost got arrested because.
I remember.
I didn't want to go through
with
it.
Put your hands on the car.
Facts. I was trying to like. I was trying to like.
I called you, nigga.
So I called them. I went out, so I changed my mind after I called them. So I went outside. I seen them outside, so I tried to, like, leave. And I'm thinking, they're going to leave? But they stood there longer than I thought. So I went up there like, what's going on? I'm like,
isn't it
like,
did a you call misdemeanor? The cops?
I'm like, nah.
Isn't it a misdemeanor to call the cops and not really have anything going on?
Yeah. So,
there you
like,
go.
That's why I got in trouble because I called the cops and I tried
I'm
to
good.
Like, I'm like, yeah, nothing happened. I called them. I was, my bad. I was.
Can you call them back?
But
call
you know what I don't
back
like?
And be like,
but
hey,
this is
false
what, I was, what I will say. So like, that's something that Jay said from the beginning. But you know, what pissed me off in like our first like year of dating, we weren't even
on,
there
wait, really
yet,
quickly,
and he called
this,
the cops
wait,
prior
this
to even
is funny,
there.
This is funny. One time, I remember, I swear
I
to God, when I was younger, when I
that's
was younger,
though.
My brother called the cops because he couldn't find his video game.
Hey, yo.
So my mother had to tell them, like,
well,
no.
Back to the boundaries, though. Back to the boundaries. I say I don't have requirements because it changes. And as I understand different things, like, I can't, granted, both is wrong. Let's put that out there right now, right? Putting your hands on somebody is wrong. However, also intentionally triggering you is wrong as well, even though if I don't know. Like I'm saying, and
but
I
but what
like,
about unintentionally triggering
but no,
you?
But Grace. No, but yeah, that's what I meant to say. Unintentionally Grace. Triggering you is wrong as well. Yeah. So if I trigger you, right, and you put your hands on me, I then have to, for me, I can't speak for everybody else, I should be understanding and like, you know what, looking at what I did, what I played a part in it. When, so if I played a part in
but
it.
But I do agree that both sides do need to do better jobs at healing because like at the end of the day, the triggered and the one triggering.
But, that's
but when
did
that conversation happen?
That. When the boundaries get set because you will know not to trigger somebody a certain way when they set those boundaries.
Okay,
so that draws the line between.
That's why I said communication.
Okay, so
we gotta
okay.
let it be known.
So I would like to go just around us and see where our boundaries are because one of my boundaries is like, I came in like, I don't like no friendly ass nigga.
There you go.
I didn't.
It's a boundary.
Like, straight up. Like, I was like, I don't do that friendly ass nigga shit. And me and Jay would
so
go
basically,
through things.
Oh, okay.
So
because. Okay.
So
I couldn't,
a more like, depth example would be, like, a boundary is you can look at bitches on Instagram, but you better not like it. And you better not comment.
And
those
not,
are boundaries.
So, and a boundary.
Some people say you can like the picture, yeah. Don't comment. That's okay. A boundary.
Because, like, for example, a boundary that I feel like I said kind of is like no surprises. Like I don't like surprises.
Okay.
Right about
yeah.
you, about the
right.
person. Like I'd rather you tell me right. than somebody come outside like,
yeah.
yo, you know, such
yeah,
and such,
such
is a dealing
yeah.
or did X, Y, and Z because I hate surprises because it just.
But all these, I feel like all of these boundaries are so subjective because
right.
we are all human.
Hold on, but no, because
but
everybody
I'm not saying that they can't
that
be
they
crossed.
Can't
it says a boundary like, is a limit of a subject or sphere of activity. So like I said, Instagram, for example, a limit of a subject or
right.
activity. So Instagram is an activity. So you can use Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
You can look at bitches, but you better not comment. That's a boundary.
Oh, it's so many. And again, I just feel like, and now I say this because hypothetically, right? We're all individuals. So you can't expect me to stop being who I am because I met you. So for example, like I was a guy that like all pictures. I like pictures.
Hold on, you can't expect it, but that's why you let it be known and you set that boundary because you can do whatever you wanted before you were with me. And I don't want to take away from who you are as a person ever. However, what about me? Because I don't be with niggas that do that. So right then and there, you can't be with me.
So
unless you work on that. It's a compromise if it's worth it.
Right. So that's what I'm saying. I say I don't because it's a compromise. I feel like it's no compromising of what you really want. And maybe that's something that I'm still learning. For me, I'm very literal sometimes. So like when it comes to something that you really want, it's no compromise. So when you can compromise, I feel like
nah, I disagree.
It's not.
I think it's when you need, you can't compromise.
Okay,
when
cool.
you want, you could come to a joint.
Nah, facts.
Certain things, and it's funny because I tweeted this the other day. I said, people need to understand that everything is not a compromise. Some shit just does not align with what you desire.
Yeah.
So,
and
right,
that's
question.
Okay
but
too.
What I'm saying,
yeah.
But honestly, I just feel like when you say some things don't align with what you desire, that's the Mahi's Bernie. If it don't align with what you desire, I feel like you can still compromise because think about
yeah.
it. It's been times where cheating don't align with what you desire. It
hold
doesn't.
On, but does it result? But does it result well? Because people compromise all the time in marriages. They say, okay, well, you know, I'll compromise. He wants to marry me. I'll sign this prenuptial agreement, but. Once it's time to divorce, now you see, like
but
Dr. Dre and his wife, now
get,
you see lawyers coming in.
That,
oh, I didn't mean that.
Before we get into that, I'm just saying, cheating doesn't align with nobody's, it doesn't align with what
that's
you
that's not true. Some people are okay with polygamous
but that's not
relationships.
It's not cheating.
Polygamous no, it's not. You're
not,
right. You're
so
right.
Again, so cheating doesn't align.
But cheating doesn't always look like sleeping with somebody
but hold,
else.
I know, but that's what I'm saying. Mm. But either way you put it, cheating doesn't align with it. Somebody getting their hands put on them doesn't align with it. However, we compromise because
of the level of understanding. We compromise because the level of love. You know what I'm saying?
We and compromise, but if there was no boundary set in place, you wouldn't even understand that something was being violated.
Yeah, 100%.
Question. To segue a little bit, right? Do you feel like you can set a boundary for the other person? Like, no. Because I see something that's in place
and
that can help
and
you.
And that's where I'm going.
Hold
that
on,
I'm
setting hold a podcast. On, hold
but I was going to ask,
on.
Like, do you feel like that's
I hate a- to do it. I hate to do it. But I think men and women are different when it comes to that.
Of course.
Because I think that as a woman, if I am not willing to negotiate on something and it's something that I expect from you and it doesn't have, it's not a reflection on me. It's just that I expect for you to do this or not do this. If you don't do that, then you're not for me. Okay. But I feel like men are a little bit more broad when it comes to
that. But I was going
to
say, but like, so I'm talking about sending a boundary to better the right, so, other person. So, though,
so
in that
two
capacity.
Things I'll say, like, so I remember, like, you know, I like in the beginning, like I said, I didn't like friendly ass niggas, right? And Jay has expressed, like, you know, he never really had those boundaries with like certain females' friends. So he never knew if he was crossing a boundary because he was kind of doing his own thing, right? Vice versa, like for me, like I don't know, like, you know, some girls can do a lot on Instagram, like whatever, but at, with a boyfriend, like if I post a too provocative picture, he's like, nah, like you get what I'm saying? So
not me.
Well, honestly, my daughter, I hate to do it. No, listen.
I'll tell you a time right now.
Tell me.
Hold up, I hate one to do time. It, but with my baby daddy, I make my money off of Instagram.
Time out,
hold up, listen, and I helped him.
This. I ain't gonna
hold
lie.
Up, I know, I'm gonna let y'all get to it, but I literally used my income, which was at that time 100% from Instagram, to help him in his legal situation. And you know what he said to me?
What?
He said, you know, I don't want any more money from you. I said, why? I'm thinking he's like, because you did enough. He goes, because I don't like the way you make your money. I said, excuse me?
That's
he
a
said,
boundary.
Yeah,
that's
the
a
way
boundary.
You take, the way you take your pictures and stuff, like, I understand it, you but
know,
I don't respect it.
You know what else is a boundary before
but
we get into this
But you respected the
shit?
Money.
But you know what else is a boundary before
you
man
know what?
Before man trying to get into this. The shit.
You know,
right,
you know,
right,
you know,
right,
you know
right.
Else, you know what else is a boundary?
That's how that ends.
That I ain't fucking with that you keep playing. This nigga told you. Stop bringing his fucking name up in his podcast. You bring his name up.
Hold up, I'm gonna be real with you. In that conversation, that's a perfect example.
I'm not trying to hear none of that. He
listen,
told you not to
no,
stop
hold
bringing
up.
His fucking
Let
name
me
up. You keep bringing that man's name
Let
up.
Let me finish. That's the perfect
My
example.
Baby daddy.
Because in that specific
Say
conversation,
somebody.
I told that beautiful person that I can say your name in whatever I want as long as it pertains to my truth. Now, if it's something about you that has nothing to do with me, cool. But if it's something that has to do with me, then I'm saying it. And he called me back 2 days ago. So this is okay, everybody. And he said, you know what? I don't even care. Say whatever you want because that's your life. Who am I?
You don't mean that shit, girl. He ain't me. He not meaning that.
So it's okay for me to say, but he okay. said that. So it's okay for me to say it. So we both set our boundaries.
Respect. So get,
if,
me,
if I can't talk about him, if it ain't got nothing to do with me,
facts.
But if it got something to do with me and so everything
me,
he do got something to do
so
with
me, get,
I'm going to talk about it.
Let me get into this. I'm going to tell you why Sade is cap, right?
I didn't even get to
when I first,
you asked me to say where you ain't even living, but go ahead.
Sade, because the question was, you said,
Alex asked if you can make a boundary for the other person. And
no,
I said,
that's not what I was about to talk about. When so she said something about
he
pictures.
He wanted to talk about that picture
look,
shit.
Right, and you was like,
it's
nah,
about
because
him low key.
I answered to when Alex spoke, not when Jasmine spoke. Jasmine spoke when I brought up the pictures.
Okay, so he's answering to me.
I'm saying.
I said, is it a boundary for her to take provocative pictures on Instagram? You said, I don't
no,
even care.
Right, and she was about to say the opposite. And
no,
I wish you would lie.
I was, okay, our questions are intertwined because I'm answering Alex.
Alex wasn't
question.
Talking. Jasmine
okay, so
was talking.
Right,
like, how do you ask
it? I got it.
It's
about
him.
It's like
it's
the
brain.
All
right.
I'm going to bring it home.
Sade, go ahead. Sade wasn't answering the question. It was an intertwined question. Go ahead.
I'm going to bring it home.
Go ahead, Sade.
I'm going to bring it home off of a real life example between y'all two. Boom. You don't care about her posting provocative pictures on Instagram, but she called me last week and said that you was hating when we said we was about to go take pics. Oh, what you an Instagram model now? Boom! Boom! Tell DJ Clue drop a bomb on it. What's up?
Drop a bomb.
What's up? What's up? What's up with the what's up, Jay?
Oh,
look, he ain't got nothing
now.
You thought I ain't know?
All right,
right, so hold
that
up.
Shade.
So one
subtle shade.
So hold up. One. Now you got rapping. One. No, I'm not rapping. Jay,
rap shit going up the top.
I ain't rapping. I'm Diddy. I ain't rapping. I'm gonna just talk.
What I was Diddy tried. Diddy tried before.
Make sure you give us a bop.
Ain't no one. Bop. So what I was gonna say is, first of all, if we go back to what episode 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sade hate when I tell my friends shit. But here she go telling her friends everything. It seems like it, because we get all the tea from Jasmine.
Hey, I ain't no tea spiller. I ain't no gossiper.
But anyway, I ain't mad at that. I ain't mad at that. All I'm saying is fairness. Okay. When I do it, don't get mad at me because you're doing the same thing. But anyway, hold up.
Does she get mad at me?
She does. Hell yeah, she hate that shit. But anyway, I'm not mad at it. What I will say is,
but you just shady
about
it.
No, I did say that. And it looked like hate.
No, just tell me why.
No, so it's really just like,
no, just tell me literally why.
It's just talking shit.
Why are you talking shit about that?
I don't know. Like you said. What you said earlier.
Because
like,
you feel a way about it? Because the nigga got boundaries. Hey! He said he had none.
I'm the one that told her she should show her skin on Instagram. She was like, I'm a mom. I'm the one that told her she should do it.
So when she does it on her own accord, it's okay.
I'm part of that conversation,
though. So when she does it on her own accord, it's not okay. But when you tell her to do it,
no. What I'm saying is, you win. No, what I'm saying is, again, I'm just being honest. I was just talking shit. That's who I am. I talk shit. Like, even if she was to get a talk show and I don't know, she getting mad interviews, I'm like, oh, you Oprah now. Like, I just talk shit. Like, I'm not.
Shout out to Jay. That's a hater.
Shout out to Jay.
I don't think. That's just me. Like you said.
But that's that motivating hate. Like, oh, I got you. I'm going to be Oprah.
Like you said.
You better be Williams now.
Like you said in the bathroom, right? You said Gemini's got weird humor. Like, they will laugh over a nigga, like somebody tripping and falling.
Yep.
Like, me, it's just like, I don't really mean nothing by it. I'm just talking shit. And I can, but at the same time, I'm not about to be ignorant. I can acknowledge and see how that might look like hate. And I work on it.
Okay.
But I'm not hating. Like, I'm not, that's not hate. Like, I'm just talking shit because you're an Instagram model. She hasn't ever been an Instagram model. So I'm just talking shit like, oh, you're an Instagram model.
Yeah, but you said we could change all the time, baby. So
again, what I just said, I'm just talking shit.
Oh, you a troll today.
I'm just talking shit.
Look, she a troll today.
I'm not just keeping it a
buck. Oh, you a troll. One, she should have came to me and I could have worked on it. But I'm glad it's coming out now because I'm fine with it.
Okay.
If you think it was hate, I apologize. I wasn't hating on you. I'd be wanting you to get your IG model shit on.
Wait. I got a question. Wait, hold on.
Next time Sade gets to take a picture for Instagram, I want you to say, Kylie Jenner, she's coming for
I'm not saying none of that. I like niggas to be, I want niggas to be in her DMs. Like, I like that shit. I'm a nigga. I got ego. Like, I want niggas to be, you know what I'm saying? I want you to be, do your thing on Instagram.
Can I answer what I was going to Alex?
You can't, because you wasn't going to ask shit about Alex. Jazz was talking. Go ahead. Go
Alex,
ahead.
Come to go the forefront,
go
right?
Ahead. Oh my God! Go ahead, answer the question. Answer the question. Answer the question. Answer the question. Why y'all stirring? Why y'all stirring it up? Y'all stirring the pot up. What's going on? You see how women do it? You see this?
We said no men versus women. And this nigga playing sides, but he doing it subtle. I don't like that.
It's always a nigga. I don't like niggas who hide their hands and throw rocks. That's all I'm saying.
Alex don't like surprises, but that nigga surprises us every episode.
Every time.
He went from celibate to knocking the bitch down. To go into it, no men versus women, to anything Jay says is okay, but anything me and Sade says.
What?
Well, no.
I stand on my chin as a man now, because y'all stirring me up. The streets be lying. We can't trust the streets.
So what if he was saving your feelings? Because what if he really saw that Jasmine was talking and you try to respond after what if he saved
y'all
your
doing
feelings?
It again. Alex, y'all doing it again. Y'all doing it again. Come on, Alex. Put him on the spot. And pass the hookah.
Tell us what happened.
You just passed it to me.
Tell us what happened.
I want it back.
Be honest.
What's the question?
I deserve it. Exactly.
What was the question you're
Alex,
answering?
You asked, is there ever a time that you feel like you had to set the boundary for somebody else?
Yeah.
But you wasn't.
You didn't get the answer.
She was.
But right, go ahead.
Okay. Say you sorry.
I apologize.
Thank
all
right. You.
You can never say that.
You just said in the beginning of the show that I apologize and you read my text.
Jasmine was talking. Go ahead.
Yeah. What are we talking about? Girls,
a big contradiction.
The show
a big
right
contradiction.
Right now, because y'all are wilding. A big contradiction. Niggas.
Are we hypocrites too? Because now we doing
niggas.
It.
Niggas.
Now
nobody. We doing it. Nobody. Contradiction. Niggas. What the fuck is you talking about?
So answer the fucking question. You don't even know the answer.
Yes, I do. So first of all, just to rewind, Alex said, is there any time that you had to set the boundary for somebody else? I brought up the time where I said, I don't like friendly ass niggas. You said, wow, I never had to set the boundaries, but now I see why I do have to set the boundaries, right or wrong.
We have to respect the boundaries.
Just right finish. Or wrong. Okay. So then I went to vice versa. You don't like, you know, when men typically don't like their women being overly provocative. I remember a time last year where, remember I got back in the gym. Like, I was wilding, but I was putting on weight. I was happy because I could fit my
talk
jeans
that
again.
Talk, sis.
Right? I was happy I could fit my jeans again. I got on the Instagram. You know, show my little waistline, show my little jeans. The nigga hits me a whole, you know, like, I just feel like, you know, as my girl, you know, I don't want you out here like that because it seems like you over here trying to be like such and such.
I'm going to tell you, whoa. Rah. Wait, tell me.
Wait, hold on. Finish your
You're
lying.
She aired you out.
No,
she just gave me. Give me the Eddie. I'm hunting them down.
I'm about to make her look stupid.
Bow. She just hit you with the. Bow.
It wasn't a bow. I'm gonna
she
tell you
did.
Why.
She aired
I'm
you out.
I'm gonna tell you why she didn't air me out.
Okay.
I need you to repeat that over and go slow. What did I say?
She like cool.
What
you
did I say?
Die slow. I got
what
you.
What did I say?
So again,
what did I say?
I was in my jeans.
No. What
you
did
said,
I say?
Let her
you
talk.
Said, you know, as a nigga, you said I don't want my girl doing stuff like that. It looks like you're trying to be like such and such.
Okay. Cool.
You
stop.
Didn't say that.
Stop. Yes, I did.
Okay.
I'm gonna tell you why.
Okay.
This so is how women.
Right,
don't, and
go.
I said this yesterday before we got to the point of let's go our separate ways. Promise. The last
though.
Thing, no, the last thing I said, I promise, I swear to God, I said, yo, I feel like you're not listening to understand what I'm saying. I feel like you're not listening to hear me. You're listening and then you taking it and running with it. What she just said in response, I feel like as a man, it doesn't look good because you're trying to be like somebody else. At that time, you had a friend that I've been speaking about.
But
hold up. No. I'll let you talk. No.
I got a buzzkill too. Go ahead.
So at that moment, I'm speaking about your friend is doing too much. I feel like you're following the footsteps of your friend. I don't like you doing this because people are going to associate you with your friend. And guess what happened? Hold up. Time out. Guess what happened? For all my friends that know, a situation happened with her friend and it came back full circle.
Hold up.
She called me about that too.
I'm going to
hold up. So guess what? I'm like, yo, I don't like you. I feel like you're doing this. It ain't about provocative, right?
Uh-huh.
It's about the reason you're doing this. I feel like, I'm not saying
she didn't tell it.
Okay, but go ahead.
I didn't say this was your reason. I'm not saying this was your reason. I'm being very fair. I'm being very fair.
Once she told you her reason, did you now accept?
No.
And
I told him my reason,
what?
No.
But guess what? Guess what?
Go ahead,
but guess
let
what?
Finish, I'm
Grace.
Gonna,
what? But guess what? I can acknowledge
Grace.
That. And I can say, I can say, you know what? Maybe I didn't. And I can acknowledge that.
Okay.
However, she can never acknowledge what I'm like.
We're not
I'm saying
about that right now.
Okay.
So what I will say is, so what happened?
Alex,
was,
come
right
to the forefront right now.
Fuck off, Alex. So what I will say right now is, so I said, really, Jay, I went down my timeline before I was even friends with us. I said, this looks like that. This looks like that. This looks like that. So what are we talking
so
about?
So can I, all right, so what can
what
I can tell you?
What are we talking
I'm
about?
I'm going to tell you all.
Right.
So hold up. Answer this question. When we first got together, you didn't really want to show your skin on Instagram because you were a mother.
That's not what happened. Jay was pro me letting Amaya see me in like my club clothes. And like, whatever. I said, she's a girl. I don't never really want her seeing me like that.
All right.
Because wait, can I just say, since I know this is going to be on video, I just want to say, it's a lot of lights on me right now. If y'all can see the background, that's why I'm sweating. I ain't no sweaty
hey,
bitch.
Hey, Jess.
And I
hey,
smell
hey,
good.
Hey, can I ask you a question? I'm going to tell you, I'm going to just get
I,
to the
I'm
end of.
I'm going
to finish. I'm sorry.
Thank you. So he says, like, I had a problem with being too provocative. It wasn't on Instagram. What happened was, I didn't like Amaya seeing me in like club clothes, but Jay was like, nah, she needs to see everything of who you are. And I accepted. I was like, you know what? She's right, right? This was pre-Amaya having Instagram, right? So
Okay,
right? So after that, Jay was like, nah, let her see everything who you are because it's not like I'm something much more than who I am. You know what I'm saying? I'm not like wilding. So it was okay. And I was okay with it after that. But it wasn't because I was like, oh, I can't. And mind you, the video was just me in jeans and my waistline. So I went back to show all the pictures. I was in jeans, you know, ass tooted up because it was real fit and right. And I was showing the same thing years before that.
So all right. So just like I acknowledge everything, I need you to be totally honest, right?
Okay.
I'm gonna go to your Instagram.
Go ahead.
Matter of fact, even before that,
we were in a restaurant, right? Mm-hmm. Sade picked out a picture that she liked when she got a photo shoot.
Yes.
And she said she didn't want to post it.
He said, show your ass.
Right.
Babe.
So so hold up. So that's,
but
I'm just,
I never did
but
that.
That's
I'm
just, hold up. But that's because, that. But hold on, Jay. That goes back to what we said before. That's because you okayed it.
Hey, so that's my point. Listen to what I'm saying.
But
listen,
without your approval,
no,
is it okay?
Listen to what I'm saying instead of trying to listen to defend. Listen to what I'm saying.
Okay.
So again, she had on jeans. That's not provocative, right? That's not provocative.
So why are you writing it?
If you're listening to what I'm saying, I said it. Your friend will always do, like, I feel like it was thirsty things, right? You don't have, you can have jeans when it's not provocative.
But my jeans.
Hold up. Hold up again, right? So it's a post that goes way, way back when she was on the beach and I think y'all was together.
Yeah.
I'm the one that said, post it. I'm the one that been pro this all the time. However, if I see that the patterns are changing, it ain't about it being provocative. I feel like you're doing things that looks like what she's doing. Hold up.
Yeah,
and
what I said to the camera, I ain't never doing nothing a bitch doing ever.
And that's
why. And
then
I
don't
know
how to
listen
to
But you're listening to your cousin.
Wait, I'm gonna agree with you because I'm not saying that you ever copied a bitch.
With?
I'm agreeing with the fact that because I feel like my mother has done this before. When I'm younger and I'm hanging around certain people, she'll be like, "Oh, you starting to talk like." Woo woo. And it may not be something I noticed, but people rub off on you. Good people and bad people.
So hold up. So
he
hold up. Let me finish.
Like
so like for example,
negative,
and I'm just really defending my character, honestly. Like Amaya, right? Amaya came to me about boys. As her stepdad, as her dad, fuck all that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not okay
shots
with it.
Fired.
It's not no shot.
I know.
First,
it's
don't
true.
Play.
True,
I ain't no
true.
Trust me.
True.
I don't throw shots.
Bow.
Stop. I don't all throw shots. So again,
and I came through and I was like, period.
No, I don't. I'm not even doing.
I had a follow up. I'm so sorry.
No,
okay.
I'm not doing.
I show
her people's mad love.
I don't give a fuck about smoke, but it was that.
Yeah,
me.
It's not. Wait, I don't give a fuck about smoke. I'm just not throwing no shots.
Nah,
I come
baby.
Direct. So anyway, what I'm saying
period.
Is, that's her pops, right?
Okay.
It might be things that I don't agree with. However, if this is what you want, okay, I'm willing to meet you halfway.
Compromise.
She came to me and Sade was like, she came to me and I felt like it was because her friends, her reason was because her sister had boys, her friends had boys in the phones. I'm like, come to me on your own time.
Right.
So I'm just reeling in and it makes sense.
Right.
The conversation, I swear to God on my life, right? I told, she just said it. She said, I feel like you're trying to be like this. And I'm like, yo, you're not listening to me. And what I mean is, it looks like, even if you don't agree with it, I'm not saying that you're a follower or anything, but
truth.
For me, all right, that wasn't your truth, and I respect that. However, you got to respect what I'm saying.
Uh-huh.
I'm saying as your man, it looks like you're following behind this, and I don't like that. It ain't about the video.
Okay,
a boundary that you set within the timeline? Or?
I mean, I was really just trying to say, yo.
Okay, hold on. I got a perfect question.
Go ahead.
So, do you, because you said it yourself, your requirements and your boundaries change.
Hell yeah, of
based
course.
On time and who you're dating.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
So do you ever feel like there's a situation where you may have felt like it was provocative, but you got to understand your bitch got a curvy body now. So
never.
Now that's what comes with
never.
That. And Alex, can you remind me of, it was an interview. I saw it surfaced this week. And do you remember the girl was telling what her requirements and boundaries were,
and
the guy was humbling her,
and
he was letting her know, like, you are expecting this and requiring this, but you're not that.
Yeah,
so you don't deserve that.
She wanted a six-figure man and all of that.
But she made six figures.
And he was saying, you don't know anybody that's six
but
figures.
He said,
like, how can you?
No, he didn't even. He also said, but you're not even attractive.
Yeah,
you're not attractive on
that
level.
I mean, yeah, that was later.
She called
it, but
she said herself that she was a five. So now he said, men don't care. It's
right.
A beautiful
well,
picture. I took
it
that.
Is.
Shout
but
out
no,
to me.
But what I'm saying, I was.
Wait, let me just say. So,
right.
So, men don't care about all of that. Oh, you make six figures. If they already have their own six figures. Mm-hmm. Now it's, but do you look good? Do you cook? Do you clean? Are you cool? Whatever else you have it. And I feel like it goes both ways. Sometimes we have these unrealistic boundaries, requirements, or expectations of our partner. But we have to understand that our partner is not that. So if Sade wasn't curvy and she posted the jeans, you probably wouldn't have thought
no,
it was
that's
provocative.
Not, and what I'm telling you, that's why I showed this picture.
But do you? But
this
do you
is my
think,
first. This
but,
is for the
but
first
do
picture.
You, but do you think that that's a real thing?
Yeah, but we're not talking about that. We're talking about us. I'm only talking about
and
us.
And I'm talking about
and I'm
y'all.
Saying no.
So you
and
never dated a girl who didn't have as much.
Yes,
and she posted,
and
you said she was being provocative. No,
listen, what I'm telling you. And that's what I'm saying. Y'all not listening.
Yeah,
no,
yeah.
Y'all not. But now,
okay.
Like, again, I get the jokes. I get the jokes. But let's bring it home for a second. Let's be serious, right? You're not listening to what I'm saying. I pull up this picture because, and you can correct me if I'm wrong, this was the first picture that she ever took showing anybody curves and all. Curves and all. And I was pro that. Again, what I said in the message was, I feel like you're following behind somebody else.
That was before that, though.
That was after.
That picture is well before that's what, that.
But that's hold my on. Point. You got to. Wait, that's that my was point. That. That was her when she was slim.
I need y'all to listen. I keep saying that. No disrespect. What I'm saying is, this was well before that. I was okay with this.
Because
is this
she not, was slimmer.
But she still, is this not provocative?
No,
fellas,
so wait, hold on. Let me break down what I think. Let me, okay, let cool. me, so wait, wait, hold on.
All right, so even that, even our that, even that.
Wait, hold,
right,
hold, hold,
hold on, even that. You're showing
that
your
was
ass.
Before that too.
So hold up, and that's my point. It's, it is before that.
Was before
so
that.
Are you trying to say?
That's my point, you're missing. Listen.
Are you saying that the consistency after the fact?
Is no,
it's not. This was consistency before the fact, so that's where we're
what am I saying? Let me know, let me know. So again, my point is, all these provocative pictures was before I said what I said.
Right.
That's what I'm saying.
Right.
When I said what I said, I just said it. Say it again, and I said, say it slow. You said, as a man, I don't like you doing this because it looks like you're trying to be like somebody else.
But if
and
I was doing it goes, before
you
that,
proved your
that,
point.
That, you
proved your point.
If no, I'm doing no. it before that, then it's consistent.
Okay, cool. That's
what
your point. What's my point?
About?
Let me know. If
no,
you,
but
if you
I'm
listen,
okay,
you don't have to ask me what I'm talking about. So my point is, again,
that's my point. What?
Again, my point is, right? In the way she was doing it, right? I said, it looks like you're following behind your friend. Her friend, like, Sade doesn't do this a lot, right? Her friend is the type of girl, well, her ex-friend was the type of girl who does this on, well, whatever, her friend, whatever the case may be. We ain't saying no names. Her friend was the type of girl who got on her story and just been doing all this. And I'm like, yo, that's her.
So, Jay, what was the difference between the pictures she posted that were provocative before and the pictures that she posted after?
Hey, fellas, can anybody tell me the difference? I feel like I explained it.
You just know.
It's the fact that you're trying, it looks like you're trying.
But she already was doing it. So how is she trying now?
She's already doing it. How, though?
All right, okay, cool.
Tell us how.
So I feel like, I'm going to be honest. And don't,
wait, hold on.
Don't negate my.
Can I try to interpret it?
No. I'm saying, no. No, I'm saying.
That's a boundary for sure.
No, I'm saying, don't say no because this is the truth for me. So you asking me how.
As long as you say it's your truth.
What was the difference?
The difference is the way in the movements, right? Like, honestly. Shorty would make movements and like how she, you okay. know what I'm saying? Like how she touched, like even everything, how she did it. It looked like you was doing it the exact same way.
I don't know. So
of course you don't. Like,
wait,
of course
I,
you
can
don't.
Can I ask you a question
ahead,
to kind of break down?
Go ahead.
Can I break down what I think I'm hearing? So it's like, did you feel like, yes, she had posted one or two before,
it wasn't
but
one
it was
or two.
Sparing.
It was multiple.
It might've been. But then the consistency and the way that she was doing it was mimicking.
Yes, it was
at that
mimicking.
Point in time,
and even in the message, she said, "I
don't."
She literally said in the message, "I know. I got you. And the message, it literally said, "I feel like she said this before I said anything. I feel like you're trying to be like, and that's what
that's
I'm saying.
What you said,
and,
right.
But that's what I'm saying. So when you back to the point is provocative pictures." I never had a problem with provocative pictures. You even said it before I started speaking.
But
my
it's
problem
why
was
you posting
you were trying to be like.
So, exactly. okay. Wait.
Subjective and it's opinion.
That is subjective.
So when she defended herself and said no, what was your response?
But the thing is, I think I understand what you're trying to say now.
Guess what? A friendly nigga is subjective. But
fine,
so
sure.
So what I'm saying is.
But when she explained why, what was your response?
I don't know.
You were okay with it?
No. I never was okay with it because I felt like she was trying to
but
be like somebody else.
My truth,
but when it came to,
it?
When you say, you, the, get back to the point. The
How
point
did you
was,
discover she wasn't trying no longer?
The point, I can't answer that. I'm not going to try to make nothing up. The point was provocative pictures.
Right.
I never had a problem with provocative pictures. Sade just came and said, no, I remember the time when you had a problem with provocative things. And it was because you said this. I'm saying, no, it was never because it was provocative. That was never the issue because I came into
okay,
the relationship saying, I came into the relationship saying, yo, I want you to be like this.
Okay,
it was
so your
fact
issue
that I felt
was
like,
not the provocation.
Thought of where it
your,
came
your
from.
Issue was...
You were trying
it's
to be
it
like someone.
Felt
no,
like
me,
it was,
myself,
but it was
myself.
Perception. It was perception.
No,
it was your perception.
Better,
your
right?
perception.
Perception.
It was your perception
on,
of
just,
it.
Yeah.
Of
I'm
it all.
Doing like Jay now. Let me just
go ahead,
get
I'm
it
sorry.
Out. So it's safe to say that your issue was not with, and this might be a new discovery for you right now. Your issue was not with her taking provocative pictures. Your issue sounds like it's really more with the company that she keeps.
It was at the time.
Oh,
and
my
that's okay.
God.
I'm not trying to devalue what you were saying. I'm almost asking. Do you think it was more of you don't like your girls hanging around girls who do ho shit because you think it rubs off, or do you think that you just don't want your girl
to be provocative? So I'm gonna answer the question. No, I don't want my girl around girls who doing ho shit. I can acknowledge that. Mm-hmm. I can acknowledge that. However, what my frustration is, I'm telling you what my problem was. Even in the message, even when you said the message verbatim, right. I said, I'm gonna let you go because I'm gonna bust your bubble. Because my problem is what I'm telling you. The other problem is you're not listening to my problem.
No, I heard your problem. I heard your problem.
But you don't agree.
Because that's not my truth. And when I told you.
But is it a boundary? Is it a requirement?
No, it doesn't.
But is it? That's your truth.
But is it a requirement or a boundary for you that your significant other can't hang around hoes?
That's what
she's not one.
So, going back
because
to
you said that your friends pointed something out to you. So is that a problem for you when you feel like your girl is doing something because of who she's associated with and now your friends are noticing it? Is that a boundary for you? Like, I don't want my girl doing anything where my friends come back to me and think it's inappropriate.
That's not the problem, because that's two different things.
No, we're just...
It's not, though. I'm asking overall, do you think that was...
You want to let me answer or no?
Yes.
Right, you asked,
and I said, answer the question, not
I'm
right.
saying that's two different things for me. You asked me a question.
What's two different things?
You said, is it a boundary that your friend, like your girlfriend, is hanging around hoes doing whole shit and your friends coming to you having a problem? For me, that's two different things, because you can hang around hoes and my friends don't have anything and I still have a problem. You know what I'm saying? You can hang around hoes, my friends say something, and I might not have a problem. So for me, I don't like the fact if you follow behind your friends doing what they doing, because I've had...
So there's your boundary. You don't like...
Followers.
I mean, you...
Guess what? You don't like followers.
It's a boundary. You gotta admit it. You don't like your significant other being a follower.
I feel like that's still a different... I can acknowledge that, yes, that's a boundary.
Okay,
that
so
has nothing to do
boundaries.
With you saying, I remember it was a time
okay,
where...
Okay, we're going back to the initial point.
I was trying to get to...
So do you see how I could see... But we never acknowledge... We offered, but we never acknowledge...
What are we supposed to acknowledge?
Acknowledge that. You know what, Jay? You know, I'm... All right, no, I'm gonna give y'all...
What do you want?
Communication. Yeah. Like, exactly.
What do you want? Wait.
I'm about to tell you.
Let me ask a question. Jay, what do you want?
What I would like for you to do is say, you know what? I can see that it wasn't the problem with me being provocative. It was a problem that you thought I was following behind somebody else, and I can see that.
Okay, I can see that.
So respect. That is
you never
boundary.
Got that.
But
okay,
that's
respect.
A boundary for you.
So let's go move. Huh?
That's a boundary for you. Your significant other cannot be a follower.
Okay, so
your significant other cannot be a follower. That's a boundary.
While we're here, okay?
Yes, yes.
I acknowledge it. I can see where that was. That just wasn't my truth. It would have.
And I respect that.
Right.
Let's move on. Let's go to the motherfucking.
The shits.
I feel like I love the conversation. I don't even care about this. But what y'all want
to
talk about?
I mean, we kind of threw some of them in there. I tried to, so that we didn't have to do that.
What was the next topic though? Like,
there wasn't.
It wasn't two.
We already did.
Oh shit. We're doing good. All right. So let's go to first of all, do y'all think how do y'all feel about Boosie suing what's his name? Mark Zuckerberg.
We're not going to quote it like Boosie. It's like Zuckerberg.
Because according to him, it's other people that did worse of shit.
Well, I think.
Oh, well, let's break it down why he's saying it.
Okay. Y'all missed miss the joke.
I do
cool.
think that the. I hate that. You know, I graduated with a degree in language and literature.
You better fucking tell him.
You know how hard it is for me to suppress when I hear or see grammatical errors? I'm like,
when he kept saying took it,
but no, he was right.
Jay, every week you say, because woman in plural, it's women. Say it with the
no, I'm, first of all, fuck you. I'm from Baltimore. I said how to fuck.
And that's
it's
why
woman. I know how to spell it.
It's women.
First it's of all, woman. Fuck you. It's with an E-N.
It's women.
It's with an E-N.
But woman.
I'm not. I can't get past
one.
That.
Women is plural.
So women,
A-N,
woman, woman.
It's A-N and E-N is let's, what you're trying to say.
That's like you saying it's two, not two. Like, shut up.
Oh, yes. It is, my nigga. Two and two are two different things.
So what's two?
What is two?
What is two? Can it's we explain one, it for two. The people?
It's avenue.
Look, he can't even
what
say.
About you two? Hey, it's not you two.
Alex, count to three.
One, two, three.
Okay, one, two, three. Sade.
One, two, three.
Oh, two. One, two, three.
Fuck
Jason,
you.
Jay's a personality now.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Nigga, fuck you.
Fuck you, Doug.
Nigga, fuck you. Doug, it's two, whatever. So, do you feel like...
enough, dummy.
Man, fuck all this dumb shit, man. Do you feel like Boosie is going to win this $20 million case or not?
I don't know if he's going to win, but what I'll say is this. I do agree with the terms of his lawsuit. I think
can you break it down for the people that don't know?
So I think that Boosie's lawsuit is justified against the owner of Instagram because his account was suspended for inappropriate activity. However, there were other people that were doing worse activity, and he claims that he has their
worser
signatures.
Activities.
I was going to say that too, just to troll, so, but I'm going to let it rock.
Back to what I was saying before I got interrupted by ignorance. There, he does
respectfully
have,
though.
He does
it was
have,
respectfully.
He does have proof that there were others that were doing worse than him. Now, people,
I mean, how many signatures did he get?
He got 200,000.
Yo.
Now, hold up. Let me just explain it a little bit more. So he's saying that it affected his money, and he's asking for $20 million. But I think that we have to understand that in court, you know, you go for the highest number first, and then you kind of settle.
Yeah.
And I think that's what this is more so. Yeah. He's more so seeking a settlement than he is actually seeking $20 million. However, the only problem with this lawsuit is that he still violated the terms of Instagram.
That's what I was going to say.
It doesn't matter who else was doing it. You did it, and that was his decision, and it's his.
And it sucks that it has to be that way. But
it does, because I do think it affected his money.
I've gotten fired for doing something that everybody was doing, but I got fired because I got caught.
But you still did it.
I got fired for going to sleep on a job when everybody go to sleep. Literally, like, that's what we do.
And it's just one of those things. It's unfortunate, but you got to be that example.
You
kind of got
to take your L.
And like, I do think him being that example will tighten up the restrictions that they have on everybody else, because now everybody can't just get away because they're not trying to have these lawsuits coming left and right. Because
then it will be an issue.
I
think he said he thought it had a little bit to do with discrimination as far as
now,
race.
Now, can I ask a question? You know, I know Boosie been in the hospital. I know he got hospital bills off the roof. He missed money. Do you know what I'm saying? Does this help? Like, does that help his scenario, or does that harm it? Because does it look like almost like you're really doing this because, nigga, you need some money?
Hold up. Let's be real. Boosie is somebody who's very popular. He's always sustained his popularity, even coming home from prison, which is hard to do. And I don't think that Boosie, necessarily needs money. Come on, y'all.
Not for no hospital bills.
We can't count his pockets. We can't count anybody's pockets.
First of all,
one.
You can I got hospital bills out the ass that I ain't paid yet. Nothing happens with that.
But I think he has a whole issue where his leg almost needs to be amputated.
No, but they saved it already.
So what I was already done. First of all, we don't know because we don't know these guys' situations.
Can't count the
My cousin almost had her leg amputated when she got shot.
No, not even.
You're talking about the money situation.
Or the fact that his expenses might be higher than the money he has.
No, but what I'm saying is I don't think
that
it's about the actual incident of him needing money for medical bills, because my cousin almost literally had her leg amputated when she got shot, and they repaired it, and she's not geeking for money. Not that serious.
What I was gonna say is,
I mean, is that serious?
I don't want to.
I mean, but you could. No, I'm saying the money's not that serious. You could make that money and
pay it off. I don't
want
to get too.
And you get time to pay it off.
Off subject, but you know what I was thinking when I'm looking at it is, like, honestly, that shows the importance of, like, that cult following, right?
Because social media is dollars.
Because honestly, if you, not even that though, because I've seen a lot of people that lost that Instagram, got it right back. It was more. You know what I'm saying? So this shows that, like, a lot of viral moments aren't as significant as we would like them to
be. So do you think that he was setting an example out of him? Making an example out of him?
So I don't think it's... So I'm not really speaking on Mark, right? I'm really... Or Zuckerberg. I think he might have been doing that, one. So to answer your question, he might have been doing that. However, it shows to me, what I see is like, yo, if you really had a real following...
Influence.
Yeah, a real influence, you wouldn't care because they would come back anyway because they said, Boosie, Instagram's gone.
I was going
to go back.
But I almost this could be a marketing scheme,
like,
too.
Now, for example, like, I'm going to be real.
He was running with that Zuckerberger shit. This could be a part
of it. Like, for example, for me, I know for a fact, if I was to lose my 30,000 followers right now, I probably wouldn't get 30,000 back. But I know it's other people who got, like, 20,000 that would lose it, and they would get it back in a day because that's how much of an impact they had on their following. And I just feel like that's, for me,
it was more of like, damn.
But it wasn't shows. Him losing the following. It was losing the money he would have made during the time period of.
But if you had that, if you had that real influence, you still would make that same money because you, the people coming back.
But it's but it's not about can I make it again. It's about what about what I lost that wasn't justified
through that time.
The only issue is he did violate the terms, so you can't really say you didn't. It don't matter what other people do. We're talking about you.
What you about to say, Alex?
But do you feel like his beef? Because I feel like he's going at Mark Zuckerberg, but he's a billionaire. Like, he may not have nothing to do with it. Like, his mind might be on completely different things.
You know, when your name is on something and you own it, you're a part of it. Yeah. So it's not to say that he's really going to get the lawsuit on his front desk, but it's still a part of it.
So let me ask y'all this, though.
Nah,
even if he wins, right, but they say not $20 million, $5 million is that?
It's a win because that's probably more realistic of what he would have. I don't even know if he
would have
lost.
At this point,
hold up. I don't even know if he would have lost $5 million during that time period. He might have lost $500,000.
Because it's been what, maybe 2 months since he's been.
But I'm gonna shoot high too, and then I'm gonna settle for
honestly. Wait, time out. I feel like
pain and suffering. Is
it just me? It might just be me because I'm from Baltimore. But I feel like when somebody else say two is the same, it sounds similar to me. When you say two, it sounds similar to me.
Even when you say similar, it don't sound the same.
Look at Jay was at Esau.
Okay, what about
no, I feel like
Esau?
Niggas in I feel like niggas in DC, they be like, the only thing I can say is like when they say block, they be like, pass me that block. I'm like,
I could talk real DC if I wanted to, but I choose not to.
When you just said two, like you sound it sounds the same.
No, it doesn't.
Say
but
two.
You know what's funny?
Say two.
I've
say
been
two.
Told
say two. What,
no, but two. Like no, hold up, listen. Two.
Say two.
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 But one time I was on the phone with somebody, a DC nigga, and I said two, and he was like, but you been around some Baltimore niggas? You sound like you saying that shit.
It sound like you saying
too. Because I talk very proper.
Elegant.
Elegant. Yes.
Fuck out of here. Let's go on.
Yes, I'm elegant.
Let's go on. Move on.
I'm from Merlin.
This shit.
Murderland.
I ain't gonna lie. This shit
I'm from
hurt.
Murderland.
I don't know.
We skip one though.
What we skip?
Yeah.
The Larsa Pippen one.
Oh my God. We can talk about her last.
I don't even care about that, but y'all can have that conversation. But
The people care.
The people care? They really do? Possibly.
You ain't talking about it all day.
Yo, this Casanova shit is crazy.
Damn. I've been saying damn Casanova all week, bro.
I feel like, you know what, yo? Honestly, we really put so much, not expectations. Somebody find a better word before. Lack of better words. I feel like we put a lot of expectations in celebrities because we don't know what they doing.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I remember when.
It's pressure. It's not even like, expectations. It's just the pressure.
Not even pressure, though. I feel like when I say expectations, for example, I remember when Fabulous had the situation with
Emily B.
Emily, right? Yeah. And it's like. I'm such a Fabulous fan. When I'm such a Fabulous fan. I'm such a Fabulous fan. That's the Mahi's Brandy. Mm-hmm. I'm such a Fabulous fan. When it happened, it almost like it hurt my heart. And I remember having a conversation with my engineer. He's like, why? Like, that man, you know what I'm saying? Like, you never know what that man is capable of.
Because, nah, I ain't gonna say that.
But what I would
say
is,
we put them on a pedestal.
Yeah.
A pedestal,
And I think people just
But he pretty much could have been doing everything they accused him of. I hope not, but it could have been.
I think it has to go with, too, like, just the fact that,
your two sounds similar to mine.
Yeah, that one sounded, but she been around you.
You. All right, whatever.
I hate when you say, it's one word y'all use out there. It's like,
one word that y'all
bluffing
ass.
Bluffing is, that's DC.
That's universal.
But you say something that he says to your friend, it's a term of endearment. Like, it's not
dummy?
Son.
No.
It might be, I think I see you say
fuck
dummy, and I was like, You said something that was Baltimore, and
fuck
I was like,
but
I had to understand.
I'm from Connecticut, so I don't want nobody ever get it fucked up.
I don't even know what the fuck they do.
What they say in Connecticut?
You're in the DMV right now.
Y'all wanna know?
What do they say?
Go ahead, babe. What you be saying? What you about to say?
So I feel like, you know, it just gotta go back to that, like, you know, everybody's a villain in somebody's story. Like, even when you see, like, a bigger, you know, like, you know, we look at all those, you know,
antagonists,
like those Frank Lucas and those Rick Ross and whatever, like some, like a lot of them were giving
about
back
Rick Ross, girl.
We're
talking about Freeway.
Right.
It's on the carpet. No, the coal is on the carpet. It could burn. Look, no more Mahis for Jay.
It's not lit. Fuck, calm down.
Where does this come from? Oh, this ours.
No, it's not.
Okay, back to Casanova.
God damn, back to what you saying?
I don't even think we announced Casanova. So Casanova is facing charges right now from the federal government for racketeering.
Yes. Yes. And, you know, just back to Jay's point of just, like, putting, like, celebrities on pedestals and, like, thinking, like, oh, now they wouldn't do that. And I just think, like, everybody is really a villain in somebody's story. Like, sometimes they were giving back and doing all this good for the people, but
they was getting it from. You not Casanova.
I mean, that's the government, like, but the government doesn't, and it's okay.
Fair enough.
But then also, I feel like it's not just that. It's just, like you said, like everybody has a past. Yeah. And I feel like a lot of times.
I mean, is it his past or is it his current?
I mean, it might be his current. But even if it's a past or a current, like a lot of times the fame just amplifies it. You know what I mean? So it just brings attention towards you.
It makes it, no, not even attention. Sometimes it makes you feel like you're invincible. You can do what you want and you don't got to pay no cost because now you think, I got to cover.
Yeah,
but that's not always. Let me just say publicly,
I feel like
you're invincible to the federal government knocking at your door.
No, nobody's. Everybody should know though. Nobody is above the feds.
Nah, facts. Everything I say, I just feel like y'all about to go back to Baltimore. But what I was gonna say is, if this is true or not, I feel like you know, outside of this, I feel like our celebrities and just even as a culture, we gotta be able to put 2 feet.
God damn.
We got to get 1 foot and 1 foot. We got to get 1 foot out of the game. Because a lot of times you see people get successful. They got 1 foot in and 1 foot out.
You
got
to take both feet out of the game.
This is not casting over. I'm just saying, like, we got to stop doing that because we got to get out of the streets because what happens is it catches up with us.
I mean, and kind of it's interesting that you said that because, like, going back to Boosie.
Hold on, but wait.
I'll never forget that.
Is there a way out of the streets?
Because, like, you got to
No, there is. But Boosie said it.
A lot of they men.
What Boosie said?
Boosie was basically saying. Like, I'll never forget in an interview what he was on. I think it was Vlad or something, but he basically was saying, like, you can't. Like, you can't honestly be a street nigga and in because he was like, people know where you at.
Yeah, exactly.
He was like, you're too exposed.
Look at Pop Smoke.
Like, the life that you're living, like, you can't really
Pop
be
Smoke wasn't
in
a
it.
Good example.
I mean,
like,
he was a street nigga.
R.I.P.
And he
We're talking about Baltimore, right?
He also posted his fucking, or his friend posted his ad.
We're talking about Baltimore,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, but that's what
Let's
I'm saying.
Let's talk about Baltimore.
His friend, like, but his friend at some point had to come from the
allegedly.
Streets.
And you can tell me if I'm wrong. Like, Lord Scooter.
We've seen people get all the way out of the streets. And if, well.
Name.
First,
who?
First of all,
Jay-Z.
Right. Well, but before I go in there,
I think he out of it.
Before I go in there,
go ahead. Continue.
I have no idea what they're doing in their real life.
That's
however,
valid.
We've seen people who said they've been out of the streets, like Jay-Z. One, he said that he's
you think
not,
he's still slinging dope.
He,
as
again,
a
I don't know. Yeah. He said he used to do these things. He don't do it anymore. That's what he. I mean,
you think my man still flipping
okay,
bricks?
Wait, time out.
When you're doing happy belated, by the way,
no, listen, when you're doing what Casanova is getting charged of, it doesn't necessarily mean that you are doing it. It means you're funding it. So you're saying that, okay, I don't even want to use Jay-Z as an example, but anybody who's as successful as that, just because they're not hands-on, so you don't got a somebody you looking out for that might be still doing it because you're affiliated. And I hate to bring it to the Nipsey Hussle situation, but I'm sure Nipsey Hussle wasn't doing anything.
We don't know that we can't
himself,
say that because we don't
but
know.
But he was still, no, that we do know. That we do know. He was affiliated. He was very vocal about his affiliation. You know, so it's not that you're not
it's
but you're affiliated. And in these type of charges, you don't have to be the person doing it. You just have to be affiliated.
And how
so
hard
you think
is it?
You think Snoop is still in
the my question
Uncle
is,
Snoop, do you know what an uncle is in crypt talk?
But that could just be rap
Stop.
Respect.
Stop.
But, you just the OG.
Who's gonna respect somebody that doesn't help
so you
them
think
or
Snoop
affiliate with them?
And his status is out here banging still in
Man,
some capacity.
Hell yeah, you on crack if you think anything different.
Well, I feel like he carried a name, but I don't
let
know.
Me say,
but how
smarter
like
doesn't always necessitate to no, because I mean smarter doesn't always equal to doing the right thing. You could be a smart ass criminal. Let's be clear. But I just want to say this really quickly before we move off of this Casanova subject. You know, my heart goes out to his family because
he got kids,
as someone who personally has experienced somebody being taken away from their family for umpteen years, you know, this is not something, whether he was affiliated or not, you know, this is not something that is a good thing for anybody. And it's a very hard thing to get through. I pray for the best outcome. I know they say that the feds' conviction rate is super high, but I'm praying for the best for Casanova and his family. And it's always going to be fuck the feds. You know what I'm saying? But I don't want no smoke with the feds. But I'm not in the federal jurisdiction, so don't listen to me. But
so what else we got worth talking about?
Oh, and G Herbo. I heard he made it home.
I'm sorry, babe. Go ahead.
No,
get in your bag. Get in your bag.
Because now I done forgot my thought because my heat.
But what I want to say is, yo, prayers up for Cass, man, because, like, I feel like he was definitely.
That video
a solid dude.
Yeah, he had an impact on all of us. Like, his personality was just so, you know, down to earth. You know what I'm saying? And to see that happen to a guy like him, it's like, damn.
Man, ain't none of us squeaky clean. So whenever somebody gets hung to and nailed to the cross for their mistakes, it's not like, right. Yeah. Because now we're acting like we're God and nobody should play.
But we also seen Casanova talk about, like, yo, like, I'm trying to change my life. Like, yeah, we've seen this on interviews saying, like, yo, I'm not trying to go back.
But how hard is it for him to leave the affiliation? Because I don't
so think I was going to ask that question, right? Side. So, like, it's like, when you know, to add on to what you were about to say, like, you have people that are still in that lifestyle, but you don't want to turn your back away from them. Kind of similar to,
but it's not always like, just out murder. Of the kindness of your heart. Sometimes it's out of threat to your life.
Yeah.
Right.
Your
but life, for like example, see, murder allegedly had nothing to do with it. He was just, it was affiliated with him. But like, how do you vet that and make that decision where it's like, yo, but this is where I come from?
Because
but
I feel still, like in the
that's
streets,
your favorite
I feel
word.
Like
can
in,
we look that up? Vet. You say that like 20 times a show.
I feel like in the streets, is, hello? I feel like in the streets, it's politics too. That's all.
Of course.
Pull that motherfucking wig off.
It's a code, man. It's a code. Once you in, you gotta, when you in the streets, you gotta go by the street code.
Yeah.
When you're not in the streets, you don't
but
have to follow the street code.
And
Casanova had an interview.
Hold up,
because Casanova had an interview that resurfaced, I think it was with the Breakfast Club, where he was talking about 6ix9ine, and he said, I expected 6ix9ine to snitch. I didn't expect anything less because he wasn't a street dude. So he has no street code to follow. So why is everybody surprised? He is a street dude though, and he does have street
code.
So
let me ask y'all this.
So we gotta see how
he stands in this situation.
No.
If Casanova
snitches.
No.
So let's be real. 2020, man,
not everybody else. Not everybody personally. Would y'all be upset?
I wouldn't be upset.
As
but
upset
I would be,
as we was about 6ix9ine.
I would be way more disappointed.
So. You would?
I would be way more disappointed because I'm holding him to a higher standard
I'll
of
say
a man.
This. It depends. Because I don't know this part. If he was really in it, nah, either way, dog. I honestly, I can't vet it, but the only way I was going to go, I can't.
Can we please, I don't know what it means. Can we
what
pull it up,
that?
Please? Vet.
The vet, it's kind of like.
Can we pull a definition? Yeah.
Well, are you saying it right? What is a vet?
I am saying the vet.
Because I know a vet is a vet.
But it's kind of like filtering it. Like, kind of like.
So what is the full word?
To vet it. Like, that's the best. That's,
somebody
that's a
look
verb.
It up right now.
Look it up.
All right.
To vet as a verb.
To vet as a verb.
Yeah, it's a verb.
Well, so what you about to say?
I wasn't about to say
anything. I don't think so for me. I think, you know,
I was about to say he's brandy got me leaning.
I was gonna say like, damn, like, I don't know. It's like, man, I don't even know.
Wow. Come on.
To vet someone.
No, it's not about the liquor. It's just like, because I fuck with Cass, I don't wanna see him in this situation.
Nah, you know what? For real.
6ix9ine, I never really had a connection to 6ix9ine.
So because this is a platform
to evaluate
where we speak, I'm going to hold us all accountable right now. Like I said, based on personal experience.
That's snitch on me. Fuck y'all.
Not even that. I feel like.
She's a civilian.
Nah,
fuck
because,
out of here,
listen,
like.
I think we need to treat these type of situations bitch, I'm about to.
Both of what? You always want to go to a nigga.
You know,
like,
both of my ex niggas got 55 years in jail.
I'm trying to say that I think that we.
Jasmine, this is how Jay feel.
Nigga's my parents.
I just want
to. Listen,
this is how Jay feel.
Yeah, facts.
Alex,
don't speak to us. I'm going to start acting like
that
to get my way.
Don't speak to us.
I was talking to you.
You talking to the us.
So, yeah, at Christmas, what you getting for Christmas, Alex? What you getting for Christmas, Alex?
Fuck y'all.
Nothing.
All jokes aside, though, we need to treat these type of situations with the same sensitivity that we treat situations with somebody experiencing a death in their family or losing a baby, whatever you want to have it. We have no say in this.
It's the
because
same mourn.
We don't know what happened. We don't know how they feel about it. And it's not for us to speak on. And I don't think that this is a platform that
we
should put our opinions of that on. I think we should just wish him the best, like we did with Chrissy Teigen when she lost her baby, and we should just move
facts.
Forward.
Right. I like that. Yeah, so, to be fair, you wanted to speak on the before we wrap up. Yeah.
So, okay.
She's sick. Go ahead, though.
I think that
I'm being fair. The fuck.
First of all, let's be real.
I said my part.
There's a lot of Larsa Pippins out there.
That's
you know what I'm saying. But we don't really know their situation either. But I know Larsa Pippin has been dating multiple celebrities. You know, she's legally married to Scottie Pippen. I don't know the status, but I know she. I saw pictures saying she returned home to there. But regardless, they have a son, Larsa and Scottie, who is in his 20s. Scottie Pippen Jr. He's in his 20s, and you know he's pursuing his basketball career. And Larsa Pippen was recently spotted out with Malik Beasley, who is a 24-year-old NBA player that is married. So I guess it's not necessarily about Larsa cheating on Scottie, whatever they got going on, we don't know.
But
but it's more so about the embarrassment for Scotty Jr. And so I know me and Sade were having a discussion about it, and she was saying that she feels like Larsa should move with more consideration for her son. Me personally, I don't, first of all, I'm never condoning no hoe shit. So I'm not saying that I agree with Larsa
Pippen. What's hoe shit?
You ain't condoning hoe shit?
What is hoe shit to you?
I mean, first of all, hoe shit is sleeping with multiple men when you're married.
That's not okay.
Okay, but that's
why I said, what is hoe shit to you?
Hoe shit is when somebody does something that ain't solid. So there you go. So I don't think
that's a different
solid
type of whole shit. We ain't talking about
a lot of whole shit.
That's fair.
But which includes opening your legs?
Yeah, in certain situations, absolutely.
Also, you don't have to open your legs to be a hoe. Come on.
But in sucking dick.
You don't gotta suck a dick to be a hoe.
No, you don't, but you can
being
do it
thirsty
in a whole way.
Yo, girls, these hoes.
A hoe gonna be a hoe.
Nah, but listen. And they know it.
But listen.
I'm sorry.
Be hoes be virgins,
but whatever. I thought that.
Really?
I thought that what Larsa was doing, like I said, was whole shit. I didn't agree with it. But I don't think that she should be considering her son, who's a grown man's feelings, with who she decides to sleep with. I feel like double standard. I feel like Diddy was sleeping with Cassie. Cassie was a model. Isn't Quincy a model? Isn't he the same age as Cassie? Nobody said anything about that. So
with that point, you know, you got a point. However,
bitch, I was stewing that print. I said, "Ooh, I'm gonna put it on her tomorrow."
Guess
that
what?
Way she got to
drop no motherfucking bombs.
Right.
Boom.
So all I'm saying,
Larsa still up
because the conversation still was regular as a bitch.
Fuck you, Jay.
I don't give a fuck.
You ain't get no pauses in that. You know what I'm saying? You ain't really.
I don't give a fuck what no bitch do with her box. 100%. However, like at the end of the day, her son is in college and focused on her basketball career.
His
basketball career. So all I'm saying is, as a mother, you are still in the limelight viewed as married. Like, don't be like that. To me, looks terrible. Like, at the end of the day, he has other shit to focus on. You got people in his comments and all these things off the strength of what you are doing. So as much as, yeah, it's your life, you do also associate with your son. So you are fucking up the family.
But
I'm
to her defense, it wasn't like she posted them.
But you are
a
celebrity.
Will.
So if you are out holding hands, obviously, you know, you're celebrity. Don't dumb down your celebrity. At the end of the day, you do have a son. Like me personally, as a mom, I just can't imagine. I have to think about my kid and everything that I fucking do. And granted that his son is grown, he's still
hold
your
up, hold
son.
Up,
like,
hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up. In this
cool
corner, wearing black trunks with the white top, we have, I'm gonna let y'all do y'all thing. I'm gonna let y'all, cause y'all was, what
it's
y'all was beefing yesterday. Oh, now y'all.
It's yeah always us versus you.
Oh,
what you wanna
Scorpio
do?
Podcast.
And you,
you know
and you.
Fucking,
what y'all wanna do?
And Alex,
what y'all wanna do?
You see how she, wow, you see how she trying to end you, nigga?
What y'all
like,
wanna
end
do?
End you, nigga?
What y'all wanna do?
Because it's never given that. Scorpio
because see
vibes
how we can come to an agreement on both of our perspectives and one not be wrong.
No,
but
one
you
like, listen
wanna
to me.
Nobody's
listen to me.
Listening
nobody's
to me.
Listening. And, the
and, then, and there
and
goes
the
Alex. And then here comes
49.
Alex. Well, philosophically,
hurry up and get this battery
technically,
right, bro,
you are
I'm
wrong
a,
because
you're
hurry
vetting
up and
him
get the battery right.
You're vetting. Am I vetting?
What is he talking about? But all that to say, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know,
I'm unbothered.
Done.
I'm unbothered.
Gemini Scorpio
Podcast.
I'm unbothered.
Is that the name of the episode? Unbothered.
Episode 48, Gemini Scorpio Podcast.
I'm fucking bothered.
49.
I missed it. 49. Damn, we. No, it's 49.
This is 49.
Gemini Scorpio Podcast,
we can't
episode
count
49. I'm Mr. J. Hill.
Mr. Healy. Hey.
Hey, yo. You fucking me up now.
All right. All right. All right. All jokes aside, we got to exit. Come
no,
on.
Okay. Come on. One more time. End it again.
No,
I'm
girl.
Ready.
You say your name.
We didn't even come to an agreement on that, though.
Oh!
But it's okay. We're going to let it
run. Oh, here he goes.
Now he wants to talk.
Here he goes.
Say it, it's like, nah.
Here
but
he goes.
He feels like, okay.
It's always fuck you. And
I
fuck
say,
you.
I said fuck out.
Gemini Scorpio Podcast, episode 49.
Miss Greenaway's out.
Healer Bay is
Alexander
out.
The Black
now
is out.
Now we are our B group. It's a wrap. We out. Fuck out.
Yeah.